The Stars in the home white, the Ducks in the visiting purple, and we are underway. The Western Conference Semifinals. Darryl Sidor will play the loose puck deep in his own end. He's teamed on defense with Philippe Boucher. Pumped out to center. Kirk Muller on the forecheck, can't get there. It's Muller with Stu Barnes and Jason Arden. In front of goaltender Marty Turco. Centering feet, broken up. Correa had a whack at it. Out there with Adam Oates. And the puck out of play and into the crowd. Our first whistle comes 31 seconds in.
Well, Marty Turco had an unbelievable season. He had the lowest goals against average in the modern era. And the Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario native really got her going against Edmonton. He struggled at times, but I like the way he was aggressive. I love the way he plays the puck. There's a lot of talk about his puck playing ability heading into this series. And I think that's because of the emotions of what happened with that George Laroque slash on his knee and him coming up playing the puck and some battles being taken place. But I think he's very effective in that area.
Here's just a little example. Take one way and swung it around. Led the breakout. Out of the corner. Sakura unable to handle as it pops free to Darian Hatcher, the huge captain of the Dallas Stars. It's not just his size, but his presence, which is huge. Just too far for Sakura. Zubov came over to protect. Here's Brendan Morrow to Mike Modano. Modano for Morrow. Return feed! Nearly tipped it by Jaguar. Here's Scott Young, who also had a brilliant first round against Edmonton. Morrow behind the back. Tried the center. It's taken away by Mike LeClaire of Anaheim. Finishes his check on the far side and sent down the length of the ice.
That's good speed and good movement here by the Dallas Stars. Good transition against a very good defensive hockey club. And Steve Modano nearly had that little redirection on the back end. It just missed the toe of his blade.
Adrian Lendon gets it in softly. Ruslan Saleo shooting around. Tipped to center by the veteran Steve Thomas. Lendon will put it back on the stick of Richard Matvichuk. Moved ahead to Lettinen at center. And across the line. Shoots it around. Nico Kampen into the high slot. Never gets there. Rob DeMaio doing the good forward work. It's taken away by Sammy Paulson. He'll flip out to center. Kampen will backhand in softly. And Jaguar will play it. Wrapped around, turned it over to Matvichuk. Jaguar knocking it aside. And there was some contact in front of the net.
No, I think the puck hit DeMaio, Steve. I think it hit him right in the side of the head while the two players were going towards Jaguar. And oh man.
Rob DeMaio is playoff tested tough in his 15th National Hockey League season. A veteran of over 700 games. If I had to guess, maybe he'll miss a shift. Anaheim will shoot it in and get it on goal with Mark Schwinnard. First shot on goal for the Mighty Ducks, and no problem for Turco. He's in the game. Saleo pushing around the boards, turn it right over. Jason Krog on him the far side. And Anaheim will look to move it away. Here's Saleo with a second crack at it. Never crossed the red line, but it's on goal. And Turco will gobble it up, waiting for the whistle. And it comes a bit late, probably for his life.
And Jaguar openly admits that he's not quite that kind of goaltender, and Francois Allaire is their goalie coach, and that's not something they really preach, is going out there and wandering and playing the puck.
It's such a big advantage as LeClaire has his stick tied up, because really, if you think about it, how many guys in the league are really good at it? There's Marty Brodeur, there's Marty Turco, and maybe two or three other guys that are really exceptional that can really bail out their team. I leave anybody out?
No, because you're right. A lot of them are just good at it. These guys are exceptional at it.
Right. And Rick DiPietro maybe one day. Lettinen got the shot. It was blocked. Rebound loose. Here's Barnes. Shot wide of the net. Kapanen got the little shot and just missed the mark. Correa is stood up by Darian Hatcher. Maybe an extra shot there. That's something we expect to see an awful lot of this series.
Well, one thing that Anaheim's going to face here that they didn't necessarily face a lot against Detroit is the fact that these defensemen from Dallas, they do stand up. They take away the middle of the ice. We've seen time and time again big hits from Darian Hatcher.
Oh, here's Modano flying around Carney. Centers in front, and it's picked off by Havlin. And Matvichuk will regroup at center. Madonna told us earlier today, rather, Korea told us earlier today, we're talking about matchups. He said it's not necessarily a forward, but it's Darian Hatchett just about every single time on the ice, and he's out there. And it's offside at the Anaheim blue line.
Madonna is such a good defensive player that even, you know, Dave Tippett was saying, well, Lucic is a pretty good offensive player. They're going to naturally be matched up against one another. But you can be sure that Dave Tippett is going to throw out Mike Madonna on the left wing on another line on a number of occasions to get him away from Lucic.
Hardy shoots in. Thomas is first on it. Big hit by Sedora, wiped out Thomas as he missed it on the near side. Oh, Dollar is spun around. Good check thrown on the far side there by Stefan Robida. And here's Sedor now on it. Sedor will swing it across. Here's Boucher. And it's tipped into the Dallas end, rather the Anaheim end, by Ulf Dahlin. Headman pass to Thomas. He's okay after that big hit. Matt Tkachuk will shoot it across. Still waiting for Dallas' first shot on goal. So much for a storm to be weathered. Here's Barnes. Can't cut in on Kurt Sauer. Barnes will get another crack at it. Barnes lets it go. There's a shot on goal. And Jaguar closed up the five hole. And it's cleared down the length of the ice. Matt Tkachuk go back to the touch.
Is very, very quick at getting them down.
Madonna won the draw to Matt Tkachuk, who will shoot it into the corner. Soleil away from Madonna. Rolls up the far side for Patrick Shelberg. Shelberg for Carney. Krog picks it up. Robot on him, centering the beam, goes through everybody. And the Stars able to come away. Morrow pass in between a couple of players, including Scott Young and Madonna. And the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim will settle things down. You heard the tremendous ESPN audio. Leave it, leave it. And he did. Keith Carney. Here's Rucci. Shot from the angle. And Turco got the stick on it. Kept it at the point. Behind the net, Turco will leave it there for Sergei Zubov. He himself, like Madonna, had a 10-point first-round series against Edmonton. Here's Scott Young. He's ridden off the play. All Korea. Morrow on it. Korea on him, back behind the Anaheim net. Korea still on Morrow. Good board work by Morrow here, and the strike. Finally, Lucic will come over and get to it. Reverse the flow around the near side. Comes up for a strange bounce away from Niedermeyer. And right to Vitaly Vishnevsky. Good forechecking here by Dallas, and a penalty is coming up. Will sit it out himself. 2 minutes for roughing at 7:02. That's the first minor of the game. And there you see the special teams for these two clubs from the first round. What you have to know is Anaheim did not score a power play goal and still swept the Detroit Red Wings. I think that is the most mind-boggling statistic of the first round. Nico Kapanen out ahead. Off for Lettinen. They're the forwards on this penalty kill for Dallas. The Ducks will look to set up with the man advantage. Matt Tkachuk and Boucher will play the defensive positions on this penalty kick. And Turco, of course, will help out. Back to the point now. Ozilic, tip shot. It was tipped through by Chista. And the Stars able to get to it and cool.
And the Ducks, remember, were a team that relied on great even strength scoring against the Detroit Red Wings. They went 0-14 on the power play. 0%. Can you imagine going 0-14 and beating a powerful team like the Red Wings? But no. They outscored them at even strength 10-4. So they're a plus 6 in that area.
At center, tipped in. Sedor will get there first. Barely got their head on LeClaire, and the Stars able to clear.
Good aggressive penalty killing here by Dallas, too. Not allowing them to get settled in. Trying to take away the line. Good neutral zone position right here. They can barely enter the zone. They can't enter the zone.
Same deal. Flipped out the center, race for the puck. Here's Kapanen trying to cut in. Had it knocked away. Four Mighty Ducks around him. Nico Kapanen, the rookie, getting it done. 15 seconds left on the penalty to Hatcher. Niedermeyer is spun around. Takes his man down. No shot so far on this man advantage. Has 7 seconds left on. Shelberg will reverse it. Haviland could not handle. And up the center of the ice, here's Jason Krog. Hatcher's out of the box, he'll stay on for now. Krog lets it go. The glove save, Turco, and he'll hang on. And the Stars able to kill it off. Make Anaheim 0-15 in the playoffs. Turgeon was tossed out of the draw. And now it's center. Backhanded in softly. Turco will take a look. Just got it away from Steve Thomas. Paulson is hammered along the board. Soleil was in pinching. And the puck comes free. Pierre Turgeon trying to do something with it. He can't. Muller is hit down by Soleil. And it's sent softly in. Pierre Turgeon returning. Missed the final 14 games of the regular season. And all six against the Oilers in the playoffs following ankle surgery. To see how effective he is. One thing to step in, get back into the play, but to play at the high level now that is required of the second round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Here's Turgeon picking up the puck at center. Moves to the middle of the ice, now across his own line and out to the red line. Here's Hatcher. Oh. Tricky pass by Hatcher to Zubov. Zubov sent it across. Oh. Turgeon the shot, and there's Jagr's first big save of this series.
Oh man, that wasn't big equipment that made that stop. That was a perfect move from his left to his right. A great push getting his pad along the ice after a good setup by Zubov. I thought Zubov ran out of real estate, and sure enough, he feathers a perfect pass right on the money.
How about the finesse pass by Darian Hatcher through his leg?
Yeah, nice little backhand pass reversing the flow.
And Jagr clearly is in the hockey game.
That's a good one. Yeah, that was a darn good quality save.
Here's Carney. For LeClaire, was hung up at the blue line. Boucher will pump it right back out. Ozilich can skate. They'll swing it across for Carney. I was almost wondering, Panga, the lack of shots by Dallas in the first period here. As LeClaire rips it and it's blocked. Jason Arnott the other way. Finds Mike Madonna. Madonna will let it go. Left pad saved by Jagr. And out of play.
Pretty good wood on that one, too, there. And it was just. Oh, good easy save. Another one off the faceoff. Jagr's going to play that one calmly. That's a smart play right there.
In fairness to Turgeon, he must have been at the end of a very long shift.
Well, yeah, and he's on his forehand, and it's not on the strong side, the weak side. So he's just trying to get it as hard as and fast as he can on net.
I'm sure Jagr would say, hey, what about in fairness to me? I'll be making excuses for the shooter. Loose puck to the right of Jagr. Here's Brennan Morrow. He'll center only. Carney is there. Soft pass ahead for Ugin. Full-fledged 3-on-2. Although they're slowed up now by the pass. And that shot by Mark Schwedard was deflected.
The Dallas Stars would like to give a special welcome to Wendy, Tonico Phillips, Taco Bell, Southwest Office Systems, Maggiano.
Ugin's going to go for a line change there as Marty Turco gets some water and fixes it up. So you're seeing a lot of the chess match taking place between Mike Babcock and Dave Tippett. And it's the first time since 1998 that two rookie head coaches won a playoff series in the first round. So they've had their success. Now it's a matter of feeling each other out and getting the matchups that you want. I wouldn't call it like necessarily tentative, but I call it smart. You can't go out of your way to do something against either one of these teams because of how well they play positionally.
Jagr will play it up the far side, turn it right over. Back behind it, a little tic-tac-toe, and couldn't get the tee up on the shot. Loose puck in front. DeMaio is back on the ice. Shot from the point, rocketed over the net. Zubov let it fly and caught nothing but glass. Center trying to go to Kapanen, and it's chipped out of the zone by Anaheim. Niedermeyer on the forecheck, Oates on it, center, pumps it deeper to Hatcher, sent softly back into the Anaheim end, and Ruslan Soleil will go back. It's funny because I think a lot of the Dallas players said that about Tippett as well. Certainly a change from Ken Hitchcock's reign here in Dallas.
Different coaches altogether.
Okay. Oates Krog, got a lane, lets it go, he scores! The former Hobey Baker winner, Jason Krog, has scored first, and the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim take a 1-0 lead.
This Fernie, British Columbia native, has some very good hands. Very good hands. He's starting to find the confidence with the puck. But it's an odd man situation here because he's got a player to the left, LeClaire, but he's got a shot at a better angle. This is an excellent shot from a right-handed shot, and Sidor's not doing his goaltender much right there, because basically from our Southwest Airlines goal cam, Sidor is going to slide right into the picture, leaning towards it. At the same time, your goalie's trying to make the save. That's the third goal of the playoffs for Krog.
He now takes over the team lead all by himself. Jason Krog in his fourth NHL season. Madonna shot that one wide. On the far side, Paulson. Able to get it out. Thomas on the forecheck, away from him. Dahlin can't get there. Chiguer will. And we'll leave it for Keith Carney. Carney will wind up, and that goal by Krog is taking some of the life out of the building. Here's Thomas letting it go. And Turco had to respond quickly with the right pad. And it's cleared out to center and all the way down.
That's a good shot by Thomas, because even though it was a left-hand shot on the right side, he had to get that off quickly because the defenseman's stick was there, and Turco had to make a good save with his right leg.
Jason Krog scores the first goal of this series, third of his career. Sanis Ozilinch, the only assist at 13:08. Romanov will finish his check. Here's Kariya from the angle. He rips one. Save Turco. Ouch is after the rebound, but Turco will hang on.
I've seen him score high glove a lot of times, and that kind of snapshot's not something that you see a lot from a third or fourth liner. You have some ability there, much like what we saw. It's a different role, but Wes Waltz, you know, when you see him make a play offensively, until you're in the league a little bit and you have a role, then you feel comfortable when you're in the offensive zone to make a play, make it happen. And now he looks like he's found a home there.
Speaking of Wes Waltz in that Minnesota-Colorado series, the first goal was so important there. You score the first goal in the playoffs so far this season. You're 34-13. And there you see from the first round, first period score.
10-1. They outscored the Oilers in the first period. That's phenomenal. That's getting ready for a hockey game, isn't it?
Coming out prepared, absolutely. That first goal statistic held up nicely in the Colorado-Minnesota series right until that final seventh game. Stars now trying to get something going. Dallas has just three shots on goal. Soleil bangs DeMaio. To see the puck is in the equipment of one of the players. And Madonna wins the faceoff. Stars get to it, look to wrap it around. Haviland plays it with his shin pad and able to keep the shots early. Not much doing, especially on that Dallas end. Which team has been off, Panger, for 8 days? It looks like Dallas is really in a bit of a slumber here early.
Well, they're both such similar teams, too.
Niedermeyer high off the glass. Philippe Boucher away from Lucic. Carney will stop it at center and take his time. Take a look. Tip by LeClaire on goal. Turco will take care of it. Backhand for Sidor. Sidor for Jason Arnott. Arnott off of Paulson. And back into the Dallas end. Anaheim has done a very good job bottling Dallas up to begin. 3:45 left in the first. 1-0 Mighty Ducks. Got a late whistle there, it seemed. Icing is called. Madonna had a great comment in talking about Ruchin following the Edmonton series. He said, he's Todd Marchant with size.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. Pretty good line.
Yeah, but Todd can fly, though. And no offense to Steve, but Todd Marchand's one of the swiftest skaters of the NHL.
Here's Soleil. Looks to wrap it around. It was behind Ozilinch. Now he'll take a second look and try to move away. Big time hook. He's coming out of the zone. Turco will swing it around. Here's Zubov with speed. Out ahead to Kapanen, the rookie. Tipped away from Lettinen by Soleil, who's already been very active. Ruslan Soleil for Anaheim. Shot in by Paulson. Go for a change. Here's Darian Hatcher. They'll reverse it back. Dangerous pass there by Zubov. Morrow can't do much with it. Sent back in. There's a little example of Turco's stick handling, although he handed it over to Stanislav Chistov. Here's Madonna trying to wind up away from Thomas. Here's Morrow, who's been skating backwards more than forwards for most of his career. Here's Hatcher, has a lane. Shot, score! That landing on through, or tipped by Morrow. I'm giving the goal to Darian Hatcher. His first of the playoffs, and that's not all. Back to the point. Roll it up low, work it down deep. Stu Barnes checked by Ozilich. Barnes able to get to it. And on the far side, Muller's being spun off the check. Kept in at the point momentarily and worked him deeper. Muller goes down to the ice along with Kurt Sauer. And we'll see which way this goes. Let's check in with the studio again. Here's John Saunders.
Hey, you grab this stick.
Minor penalty, 22 white, 2 minutes holding the stick.
John and Barry will see you in a minute 50, hockey time.
Kurt Muller's getting called for holding the stick, and Kurt Muller didn't like it. And I see two players just battling on the side. I didn't see much of that as well, but the referee might have been screened on the play with all the action in front. But Kurt really gave it to him going to that penalty box.
Turned over, and there's Adam Oates. Muller for holding the stick at 18-10. Anaheim's second power play of the game. The goal is Hatcher, his first of the postseason from Madonna and Morrow at 17:39. For Darian Hatcher, his first playoff goal in 33 postseason games, dating back to April of 2000 against Edmonton. And Turco able to get the stick on that one to knock it away. Back to the point. Ozilich working in deeper. Wow, and Turco involved with Peter Sikora. Sikora's down on the ice. And I think Turco's going to get called.
He said no penalty originally. No penalty. And it looked like he was warning Marty until Marty flung that stick.
Bottom line, it's a 5-on-3 for a minute and 5 seconds. The first 5-on-3 for Anaheim in the playoffs. Kapanen able to get to it off the Turco save. Turco high sticking at 18:59. Correa will swing it in. 50 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Worked across to Havlat. He finds Correa. Reaching in a high slot. Shot is stopped. Rebound loose. Still loose. Dallas gets to it. Havlat able to keep it. Here's Correa with 25 left in the period. Again, it's Sikora and Turco involved in front of the net. Correa off the give and go. Oates trying to make something happen. Oates has a lane. Stop, rebound, stop. Turco finally has it. And Matvichuk fires a left. Glove to the face of Sikora. 20 seconds left in the two-man. 11 in the period.
Good puck movement here by the Ducks. Adam Oates and Paul Correa on the one side. Ooh, that one there just bobbles it a second. And then he tries to surprise Turco by looking past and then shooting short side. That's a smart play by Oates because he's known as such a great passer. In fact, I talked to Marty Turco yesterday about some of their shooters. He said, I don't have necessarily go over a lot of video, but I know Oates, he passes more than shoots it.
Here's Havlat, cross for Correa. Down low, back to Havlat now. Finds Correa, 2 seconds left. They won't even get a shot off. Kirk Muller for holding the stick at 18-10 and Marty Turco at 18:59 on the high stick. Tied at one as we open up period number two. Turco will leave it there for Zubov, slaps it around, and Kirk Muller's out of the box, and he's got the puck, and here's Hatcher bidding for a second in the game, and Thomas will take it away.
I like the way Hatcher's moving his feet. I mean, he's a big man, and it's not easy moving him, but I think he's done a great job all year long of getting up in the play.
Shot around the boards. 30 seconds left in this 5-on-4. Here's Correa now. Looking to set it up for Steve Thomas. He finds Adam Oates. A lot of years there. Thomas to Oates. And a lot of success in postseason play. Oates, wrister. Blocked by Zubov. Didn't know where it was. Thomas in front, battling with Hatcher now. And Turco as well. Cross ice pass. Ozilich. His shot was blocked by Hatcher. And Hatcher runs Ozilich through the glass.
What a hit.
Wow, really nailed him from behind. Make Anaheim now 0-for-17 on the power play in the playoffs, and that includes a rather lengthy 5-on-3. Here's McDonald right back. Stop, rebound, loose. against Tua. He'll rub out Young. Back to the point. Good check as Ruchin has stepped into it. Here's Correa. Has some help with Niedermeyer to the front of the net. And he tried to go all the way across, and that pass was broken up. Richard Matichuk got a stick in the lane.
That's a smart play by Niedermeyer. Just drive right to the middle. Let the creative Correa do the work.
Here's Ruchin. Bumped at center by Young. And they're offside at the Anaheim blue line. With Hatcher in the action tonight, he's now five playoff games shy of 100 career. He's fourth on the Stars' all-time list, passing Kurt Giles.
Kurt Giles?
Every time I think of his name, I think of your name. You're forever linked with Giles.
He scored the first ever goal against me at the Met Center in Minnesota. Now he's coaching a high school team in Edina. Unbelievable.
At center ice. In across the line now. Paulson, pretty drop pass. As they try to set things up, Vishnevsky, it was deflected. And Soleil will come over. Vitaly Vishnevsky played just 2:49 of that first period. Gets a pretty decent chance there. Vishnevsky took his man down. Here's Barnes, and Soleil came over to deflect it away, and a penalty is coming up. And it looks like Dallas will get the first power play of the game.
Oh, wrong guy. Kachistov was going towards the penalty box, and no, not you.
Five purple. 2 minute penalty. Holy.
Five purple. That's Mighty Duck player. Vishnevsky gets taken off. The penalty is going to come right into your picture here.
Anaheim penalty number five.
Use his stick on one side. Let go of his. Once you let go of your stick, it's a telltale sign. The referees do magnify that look. It didn't seem like much, certainly, to Vishnevsky. And clearly, the balance of Barnett wasn't very good. But it's a power play for Dallas. Excuse me. Their first of the game.
Holding at 2:31. Sergei Zubov have 5 points. 5 of his 10 points came on the power play against Edmonton in the first round. 2 goals and 3 assists. Here's Lehtinen trying to break through and can't. Soleil cuts his man off. Wrapped around for Zubov now. Ruchin might have deflected that. Young, he'll be checked by Sauer. Here's Modano, takes a look. Centered in front, broken up high off the glass. It's chopped at him. Modano's going to get to it. Carney does a number on Modano and puts him down. And the crowd won't like that very much. Here's Modano again. Tried to center. Carney got to it and cleared it the length of the ice.
Well, in the first period, Keith Carney was on the ice with different partners every single time at even strength that Mike Modano was on that ice.
Shot to the corner. Soleil. He's cut off by Dolan. Paulson will get to it. And looks to move it ahead. Too far for Niedermeyer. Some pretty good penalty killing so far by Anaheim. And Darian Hatcher is slammed down on the ice by Paulson. Tip shot. Saves Jaguar. Barnes there for the rebound. Can't get it in time. And Zubov can't hold in. Wow. Paulson on Hatcher mismatch. Take it away. Shot. Niedermeyer, a former big-time scorer, gets the shorthanded goal. Here's Shelberg now for Anaheim to clear. 15 seconds still left on the penalty by Vishnevsky. For Niedermeyer, it's his first of the playoffs, ninth of his career, and it's a shorthanded, unassisted goal at 4:04. 2-1 Anaheim.
That's Madonna's job, is to follow the centerman wherever he goes off the faceoff.
Here's LeClaire, shot, save, and the rebound is pumped wide of the net. Turco got the first one, didn't have to get the second one. Race for the puck. Morrow's going to get there first and will center. And it's all the way back to Ruchin. Morrow paid for with a big hit behind the Anaheim net. Here's Niedermeyer right back, and it's blockered down by Turco. Ruchin behind the net. Modano on him. Morrow will step into Ruchin. And that allows Modano to take the puck. Zubov will slow things down at center. And out just be shot in softly to the Anaheim end. Back to the point. Here's Zubov. Let's it go. Loose puck in front. And it's clear just momentarily. Zubov. Pretty pass. Shot. Save Jaguar. Young didn't get the kind of lumber he would have liked on it. Kept it at the point. Hatcher for Zubov. Back for Hatcher. Let's it go through traffic. It's blocked down. trying to get there. Gets a bit of a screen from Carney. And the puck out of play. Rob Niedermeyer, the first shorthanded goal in Anaheim playoff history. Oh, Arden with one hand on the stick, sort of swept it wide. Couldn't get two hands on it. Westwood had a good scoring chance.
I was going to say, instead of swiping it, yeah, he had a good chance to go right at her.
You always tell me, keep my two hands on the
stick. Yeah.
Centering feed off of Krog. Good play with his skate to kick it the other way as opposed to redirecting it by his own guy. Shots nearly better than 2-1 for Anaheim over Dallas. And they lead 2-1 up on the only scoreboard that counts. Soleil will swing it across. Here's Carney back to Soleil. Tried to headman, knocked out of midair by Sakura. But it's right to Dallas. Turned over to Correa. Nico Kapanen deep in his own end. Headman pass off Dolan, slows it down. Carney cuts him off. Sauer's back court, reverses for Oates.
That's a good reverse by Sauer. Really good play, and it needs communication from your goaltender.
Soft pass. Here's Sakura. Dropped nicely for him. Boucher will go to the corner. I know it's still early in the game, early in the series. Dallas looks like they're in trouble here, Panger.
It's hard. It's hard work playing against a team like Anaheim.
Lettinen lets it go. Over the net to Mile on the far side. He was cut in the first period. And returned as you would expect from Rob DeMille. Set softly on the Dallas end. It will go far enough for icing.
His movement side to side, like all Francois Allaire's students, is so good, so darn good. It's impenetrable.
Zubov got the shot away. And on the far side, Havilil come away. Bouncing puck on Hatcher. Makes a safe play off the wall. Krog tried to step into Muller and missed him. Havilil go back and play. Good check back behind the net. Krog will move it away. Out ahead for Shelburne. Sent softly into the Dallas end. There's Turco to play it away from Krog. And the Stars will move away. Here's Zubov. Nifty move it center away from Niedermeyer. Another good move. Zubov is in. Let's it go. And it's blocked by Havlid. Check back behind the net. Vishnevsky will move it away from Anaheim. Finds LeClaire at center. Trying to split through. And instead cuts to the left. Centers off of Turco, off of Zubov, and off of Turco. Here's a good idea for Turco to hang on.
To the success of the Dallas Stars, he's one of the best transition D out there.
Turco off the draw, trying to move it over to Morrow. Morrow gave a little shot to Soleil, and they exchange blows. And it's off the stick and kept in by Sakura. Ruchin from LeClaire at 8:58. Ruchin's third career playoff goal. Second of this postseason.
The Dallas Stars and WDAZ want to congratulate.
It looks like we're going to have a penalty coming up.
Green, purple, 2-minute penalty, interference.
Interference call on veteran defenseman Keith Carney, who again, he's matched up with Madonna. And you see there, the puck has gone by him, and he eliminates the progress of Jason Arnott. Scott Young. That's a very good call by the official. Looked like a stick might have come back and hit Carney as well. But, I mean, you can't go out of your way, go onto an angle, and cut off a guy when the puck's nowhere near that player. In the old days, in the old NHL, defensemen did that all the time, especially as they went on in years, couldn't keep up with the play.
21 team league?
Not anymore. Yeah. Yeah.
The old days.
Yeah, the old days, the one I played.
Television was black and white.
Okay.
Here's Turco now. Carney interference, 9:27. Dallas' second power play, and they need to do something with it. Midway point of the game, and it's 3-1 Anaheim. And after that first round sweep against Detroit, you would never imagine the Ducks could sneak up on anybody. That's not to say they've snuck up on Dallas, but how else do you explain 3-1 midway through the first?
Their roster has changed dramatically. They were small in the middle of the year. They got bigger with Niedermeyer and Thomas and his veteran leadership.
All right, here's Madonna now looking to work some magic. Has Young in front of the net. Zubov will look to set things down. The quarterback on the power play finds Lettinen. Madonna the hard pass, the point. sends it across. There's Sidor. I think I hit Letnin, actually. Never made it on goal.
Yep.
Young trying to shoot up the boards. Lucian was there. And I guess they touched with a high stick.
Yep.
That's what they are. And I believe the faceoff will come outside the zone.
Even though they watched the Mighty Ducks do this to the Detroit Red Wings, but in game one, the Red Wings dominated that hockey game. Make no mistake about it, when you have that many shots on goal. 63 saves for Giguere in that opening.
Philippe Boucher will shoot it around. That's obviously a record for a goaltender in his playoff debut to make that many saves. That makes sense. Here's Boucher now. Try to shoot it in deeper, and it's shot out instead by Kurt Sauer. And Dallas is going to start hearing it from the crowd. A crowd that is angry to begin with. A huge hike in ticket prices from round to round. They're offside at the Anaheim blue line. Did not raise their ticket prices in the first round, but have here in the second, and they're not liking what they're watching. With two goals, that's more than in all four of the second periods they played against the Detroit Red Wings. DeMaio would glove it down, look to make the move. Got a chop on a duck anyway. Couldn't get to the puck. Sandis Ozolinch will pick it up. Oates couldn't handle. And Dallas will look to work a little deeper. Sent back behind the Anaheim net. Ozolinch hit by Letnin as he worked it up the far side for Sikora. Flipped in. Correa will chase now. Working on Turco. He'll leave for Zubov up the far side. There's Correa. Played off his skate. Oates trying to do something with it. It's kicked to the slot. Good pressure there by Correa, who's had a relatively quiet start to this one. But you know what?
Oh.
With other guys scoring three goals,
focus
on some other things.
Takes a lot of pressure off your big guys. And for Paul Correa, he's going to get his chances. You have to stress patience. And I think that's one thing that Dallas right now.
Hatcher at the point. Whistled one wide on the short side.
Being down by two. Now that you're going to start seeing individuals press, try to make things happen. And that's exactly what lures you into the Ducks. And the Ducks right now. And he makes it a 3-1 win. A 3-1 game, excuse me.
Ruchin did have his second career 20-goal season. But you think about the other guys, Krog and Niedermeyer, not traditional goal scorers. Each had 10 during the regular season. Ruchin obviously has taken on more of a defensive posture in the playoffs. So rather interesting to look at the three goal scorers tonight so far for Anaheim. There's Krog. LeClaire, that pass. And it was a pretty good pass by LeClaire. And then the shot. LeClaire made the brilliant feed to Niedermeyer on the goal. Schwinnard on the forecheck for Anaheim behind the net. Can't do much with it. Good play by LeClaire again. Turco will leave it there for Robida of Dallas. This crowd is starting to grow rather impatient with their stars. Niedermeyer at center and across the line. Here's Rob Niedermeyer showing you the offensive flashes. And the backhander on goal and the save by Turco. Matt Tkachuk and Niedermeyer come together. Madonna beats Ruchin on the draw. Work to Scott Young. They'll shoot it to the middle here. Darryl Sidor had a fine series against Edmonton. His headman pass never made it. Carney got back for the touch and icing is called. 6:11 left here in the second. This is game one of the Western Conference semifinals. The Mighty Ducks of Anaheim, the 7 seed, against the top-seeded Dallas Stars. And yet it's Anaheim on top by a score of 3-1. Dallas really struggling so far on home ice.
Well, they are. That shorthanded goal against was a deadly one. It was a 1-1 game. They were on the power play, and Niedermeyer scored his first of the series while shorthanded. That's huge. And then Ruchin scored on the turnover. So now it's a very, very huge uphill climb against a wonderful team playing with the lead.
Touch with a high stick. No reason to blow it down. Philippe Boucher looked to play it off the boards. Dallas looks disorganized. Can't seem to get anything going. Just 8 shots on goal for the Mighty Stars. And we've got 5:40 left in the second period.
Take it out!
Well, that regroup that you just saw, that's actually a good play to regroup, going D to D, waiting for your opportunity, but end up that Young had it in the middle of the ice where you don't want to be against this team.
Morrow. Pass picked off by Thomas.
Oh,
what a move by Steve Thomas. Shot. And he missed it on the short side. Might have gone off of Turco's glove. Shelburne behind the net finds Thomas. Soleil was cruising in. Back to the point. Shot. Turco to save for traffic. And Philippe Boucher on it. Here's Brendan Morrow. Morrow has it taken away. What a shift for Steve Thomas. And Thomas has even more to offer before he goes for a break.
Oh, boy.
And gets it in deep. That's all you got to know about Steve Thomas. Watch that shift. Chistov got the easy shot away. Turco, no problem. Sent Dabbling for the ice. Soleil back to the touch. Icing is called. Obviously still early, but they're well on their way to doing that again here tonight. Just eight shots on goal. Picked off. Here's Correa in across the line. And the soft pass across the Oates, save by Turco. Oates didn't get the kind of hard shot he would have liked to have. Ozilinch on it now. Lots of offense on the ice for Anaheim. Sikora, the third member of that forward line. Back the other way. Here's Dallas. And they're offside and not even close. Kapanen was well ahead of the play.
Both forwards, once there's a control breakout, the two guys just wheel out of the zone going backwards. So in essence, you got four guys skating backwards in the neutral zone, staggered, all passing lanes taken.
Jason Arnott in the battle there. He did not play in the clinching game in game six. An undisclosed injury, they're calling it. It is, after all, that time of year.
You know what? I wouldn't tell anybody.
You know, Panger, I don't mind. I'd rather be told it's undisclosed as opposed to lie to me and tell me it's a different body part. I've got no problem with undisclosed injury or minor injury, whatever it is. Just don't tell me it's a knee and it really be your shoulder. Here's Dahlin back behind the net.
If I ever get into coaching, I will do that to you.
Shot, save. What are you going to do to me? Shot, and a score! And there is Arden on the goal. 3-1, 3-2.
Down along the ice, puck down low like they talked about. Dahlin using one hand on his stick. Arnott comes out and there's no coverage at all. The first shot stopped. Rebound comes out and then he just swats at it. Jaguar's going down to the butterfly. Looks like the blade of his stick. Just didn't get on the ice in time. Arnott's got plenty of room here. A good save on the first one by Jaguar. Rebound comes there. He screened on that. It's got to be. And along the ice, innocent looking play. But it all begins with the play down low by Dahlin. And then Arnott being able to come out alone from that short side and getting the first shot. That causes havoc. And there was a lack of coverage in the defensive zone for the Ducks.
Here's Barnes now. The crowd once again back in the game. Centered and tipped and wide. Turgeon had the centering feed. And Muller was upended by Soleil. Here's Hatcher now. Fakes the shot. And with that fake, he put his teammates offside. Third of the postseason, 24th of his career from Dahlin at 16:32, making it a one-goal hockey game with 3 minutes left here in the second. And a little more life out of Dallas and their stars. Here's Madonna, and he rips one off the glass. Up the far side, there's Hatcher. Put it through the slot. Turnaround shot from Madonna. Was deflected. Here's Correa trying to break through with some speed. Correa had a step on Zubrov and then hit the brakes. Waits for some help. Shifty little pass for Sikora, who, by the way, played with Jason Arnott along with Patrick Elias. Remember that big A line for New Jersey when they won the cup. Wisniewski pushes it across to Ozilinch. Here's Thomas back behind the net. Loose puck. Dallas will get to it. Out at center. Minute 45 left. Here's Lettinen trying to break in on Wisniewski. Wisniewski the check. Back behind the net. Wrapped around on the far side. Matt Tkachuk will get to it and force it in a little deeper. Here's DeMaio on it. Away from Wisniewski. Back behind the net. Ozilic blind clearing pass. He was fortunate. It was deflected so close to him. He got a chance to set it back.
Great play by Lettinen.
DeMaio on it now. Finds Mikko Kapanen trying to make the move around Wisniewski, who lost his stick. Thomas will move it out ahead for Anaheim. and sending it softly over the chain.
That is a heck of a shift. First of all, Nico Kapanen, a great rookie season, doing a good job with DeMaio and Lettinen on the same line. They completely hemmed in the Ducks on that shift.
Here's Havilland, puts it out of play and into the crowd. As for what's coming up in the upcoming intermission, back to John and Barry. Unless, of course, the Dwayne Rollison gets the start for Minnesota.
You never know with Jacques Lemaire.
With Jacques Lemaire, right?
You never know.
Wouldn't that be something? Here's a centering feed, a shot, the save! Jaguar well out of his crease, cutting down the angle on Jason Arnott.
And late in the period like that, Dave Tippett's got Madonna with Arnott on the ice with Dahlin, and that's a good set play down low here. Madonna with the puck in the corner, finds Arnott, the big right-hand shot. This is an excellent play. Now, Jaguar made one good quick push from his post and out and eliminated the angle.
Here's off the good face-off win by Dallas. Hatcher got the shot away. Now Zubov, and the Stars have really picked it up since that last goal by Arnott. Final 35 seconds. Here's LeClaire. He'll shoot it in and shoot in softly. Niedermeyer on it. He and Hatcher go to the board.
All right.
Loose puck, and here's Arnott. Away from LeClaire, off the boards, and out of the zone. Dahlin tried to play it off his skate, settles things down, tried to shoot it in. Looked like it was deflected off his own teammate, Madonna, maybe even into the bench, with 17 and 4/10 of a second.
Now they get, with 16 seconds left, likely they'll go into the, and that puck's gone out of play again. A lot of pucks going out of play here.
Put your finger on it, Panger. The difference going into the dressing room down 3-1 or down 3-2. It's only one goal, but it seems a lot bigger than that.
It's huge. Just coming back after trailing by one is tough enough in this league, especially against a team as systematic as the Anaheim Mighty Ducks, and if you want to put it the other way, as the Dallas Stars. But one goal puts you a little bit on your heels.
Morrow and Soleil to the boards.
Hatcher down low.
And that will do it. The horn sounds, ending period number two. 1-1 after one. It's 3-2 Anaheim after two. We'll have a third period, Corey, coming up. But first, it's John and Barry on the other side. Between the Dallas Stars and the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim, yet there's already a sense of a rivalry that you normally wouldn't have without a playoff meeting. And we expect that to escalate as the series gets deeper. Play underway. Third period from American Airlines Center here in Dallas. Another capacity crowd on hand. Have not had a whole lot to cheer about. Nicholas Havilland looks to move it up the near side off of Mike LeClaire. LeClaire at center. And Oates will shoot in. Niedermeyer on the forecheck. Turco perfectly away from Niedermeyer. Arnott slapped at it by Havilland and all the way down. And icing will be called. Face off to the left, Turco. Dallas wins, and Zubov will move it away. For Kapanen. Off his stick, Carney, though, the other way for Anaheim. He'll flip it down. Left of the ice. They'll say no icing here. The theory that Hatcher could have played it. Kapanen at center. They'll drop it back. Cross ice pass is take the left and lets it go. And a stick save by John Sebastian Jaguar. Here's Kapanen. Korea went out to guard him and still guarding him now. Here's Rob DeMaio on. Mighty Ducks will get to it. Soleil able to clear it out to center. Peter Sikora will shoot in. They'll get a fresh line on for the Ducks.
A good short side shot right there. That might have even hit the post after hitting the right side of the block of the stick of Jean-Sébastien Jaguar, who holds on to a 1-0 lead in the third.
Here's Zubov. Steps through the middle and backhands in. Carney on it. Carney is roughed out, leaves for Soleil. Carney has become the workhorse on that Anaheim blue line, averaging some 25 minutes a game. Shot, Turco behind him. Niedermeyer let the hard wrister go, and Turco got just enough to keep it out.
Boy, Niedermeyer's been good, hasn't he? That's a great little snapshot. Very discreet shot. It was tricky enough for Turco to handle.
Offside. Marty Turco allowed two or fewer goals in five of the six games against the Oilers in that first series, yet he's clearly been the other guy in terms of attention to the two starting goaltenders in this series.
Let's go back to that second period and small plays. Make a big part of obviously the hockey game here, and here's the play we're talking about, the icing. That was obviously on this side of the red line, and the question mark here is we see this linesman is going to wave it off right there, and he's waving it off, and I guess the question is, it was obviously icing. One linesman looking at the two line pass, waved that off. The far linesman had the arm up for the two line pass. In the meantime, it's an icing call, but I think it's still a hard call to make because the player's right there, and it's just an awful pass.
Right.
I mean,
well, it looks pretty good now.
But it ends up being it ends up not being nice, and it ends up being a goal.
There's Harnett again shooting. Out of the corner, David Oliver's shot is deflected off Sauer. Here's Hatcher's long drive and knocked aside. Correa will get to it and clear. Just to the center ice. Back the other way. Carney, Correa. Correa couldn't get it through. And Carney will have to go back and chase it again. Morrow is cut down. Morrow cuts his man down. And here's Zubov on the far side. Oh,
that hit Young in the foot.
Shake that off, and Young's got the puck. Let's see if he goes for a change. No, he doesn't. Not for the time being. He's got the puck. Here's Young. Across the line. Offside is the call as the shot was fired. On ABC Sports Championship Television. Here's Barnes. Interesting. Stu Barnes and Rob Niedermeyer in this hockey game together. Part of that electric 96 Florida Panther team that shocked many in only their third year of existence. Made it to the finals and lose to Colorado. It was a sweep, but they were close games. Matt Tkachuk partially shanked the shot. Oh, Arnett and Niedermeyer, a couple of 44s going hard at it, continue to go hard at it. Wisniewski is bumped. Arnett's taking this thing over now as he centered through everybody, and LeClaire gets to it. Oates tipped it out the center. Niedermeyer racing for it again with Matt Tkachuk, and Niedermeyer takes it away. Niedermeyer tried the center. Wisniewski was in, couldn't get it to him. Here's Niedermeyer still on it. He'll go back to the board. Wisniewski will let it go. And a save by Turco. What a shift for Rob Niedermeyer. Jason Krog got the shot away. Turco, a spinning save. Letting in on it. And Letnin, good effort to get out of the zone, and he's still got it. Here's Yuri Letnin, one-on-one Ozolich.
And now Niedermeyer will go in and take this draw. They've won two straight.
And Niedermeyer able to win that faceoff. Win the faceoff, and normally it's the puck possession. Although Shador has it for Dallas. Young got a stick on it, but couldn't get the good shot away. Morrow's in the battle in front. There he is. Might have gotten a piece of it, and Jaguar made the save. Working on Hadlin, who's puck in front. Oh, get a stop by Jaguar. On Young. Young will center, but only LeClaire is there. One-on-one as he races out to center. LeClaire, the nifty move, really put himself offside.
Yep.
And a battle for the loose puck on the far side. Things pick up now. Here's Madonna trying to tip it to himself. It was slightly behind him. And I will get to it. Hadlin dumping softly. Osama forecheck away from him. Here's Darian Hatcher. Looking for Madonna. It was a good idea to give it to him. He likes to dump it off to the right side instead. And Ozolich will come over. Hatcher was taken down. Crowd wanted a call. And Hatcher took one of the Anaheim helmets with him. Here's Morrow. Trying to get Kapanen with speed. Sauer comes over. DeMaio will get to it. Oates on him. Tying up his man. Dallas gets the puck. Oates still in the battle with DeMaio. Not bad for a 40-year-old. Adam Oates doing the good, hard work in his own end. Oates will turn 41 in August. Here's Correa with a step. But that's not enough around Zubov. But Correa is hammered into the boards and down. And maybe the biggest roar of the night from this capacity crowd in Dallas. Head man pass just missed DeMaio. And he's rattled into the boards. Hatcher's in deep now. back to the point, and we have seen frenetic action here all of a sudden. We didn't experience any of this coast-to-coast like we did in the first. Centering feed, Paulson got the shot away, left hand, Turco. She stopped a good shift there. And Soleil will go back. They'll wipe off the icing. Hamill it on it for Anaheim now. 12:45 left in the third.
Chisov started that entire rush with some real good work on the forecheck. Put some pressure on Zubov, the defenseman for the Stars. And that allowed Thomas and Paulson to work a little give and go.
Across the red line and sent to the corner. Morrow will get to it first. Thomas really has it taken away from him. Back the other way, here's Ruchin. Ruchin across the line. Let's it go. The glove save. Turco will take a look, and he'll hang on. 12-12 left in the third. Chistov this season had the second most goals and points by an Anaheim rookie ever. So he was first, of course, Paul Kariya in his rookie season. Chistov has become a fixture on this Mighty Duck team. Here's LeClaire, who's had a very strong game for Anaheim. They're shooting in the corner. Boucher trying to swing it around. Young on the wing will pick up the loose puck. He's got Madonna with some speed. There it is. Madonna trying to beat. Oh, Carney centers in front, and LeClaire is there on the back check. Turned over. Young off a skate shot save. Jaguar was there. Ruchin lost his stick. Ducks need a clear, and they'll get it.
What a one-on-one play by Carney. Was he strong on his stick? Close to being a hook, but he was strong on his stick. There's a difference between the regular season and the playoffs. The urgency of the players, especially with Madonna blowing by on his left side.
You know, you hear about the forward matchup all the time. Obviously, Luchin against Madonna, but you see Madonna against the defense. It's like Carney's on that side every single time that Madonna goes that way. And they've been locked up and offline. It seems like Madonna is seconds away from blowing by Carney, yep. But it hasn't happened yet.
Yeah, that was a savvy defensive move, no doubt.
Madonna is so fast. Imagine how fast he'll be when Bill Guerin returns to a lineup. Barnes on the far side. Clears out to center. Guerin continues to be a day-to-day injury with the thigh. Dave Tippett told us he expects to see him in this series, just does not know when. DeMaio back in his zone, and he'll regroup.
Maybe by the time they get to Anna. I'm sure that would be a possibility.
Two-line pass, back to John. Face-off at center, drawn all the way back into the Anaheim end. Under 10 minutes left here in the third. The Ducks trying to go up one game to none of this best of seven Western Conference semifinal series, with game two set for this Saturday right back here. See it on ABC. Here's Barnes the other way. They'll shoot it softly to the corner. There's Pierre Turgeon on it. Turgeon has missed the last 20 games, regular season and playoffs. His minutes have been drastically reduced. Not playing Turgeon kind of minutes tonight, which makes sense in his first game back. Thomas will get to it, flip it out. Paulson got just enough. And Arnett will calm it down at center. Arnett taken away by Thomas, who's upended. Here's Chistov. Reaching towards the front of him. Chistov lets it go. Oh, amazing play. Still loose. Shot save. What a save by Marty Turco on Chistov. That shot is blocked. Through a maze of players and bodies and sticks and skates. And then it looked like Chistov had time for a cup of coffee. And I think Turco beat him.
Oh, how does that stay out? Chistov's been good as this game has gotten on. And that's the balance of the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. They're getting scoring from four lines.
Morrow gloved it down, couldn't do much with it. Hatcher back deep in his own end. Pushed to the Anaheim blue line, a pump right back out. Robita will shoot it around. Robita had a very physical series against George Larocque and Edmonton. He does pushed out to center. LeClaire will try to chase it down. Robita on the far side will skate away. Morrow's onside. He's checked by South. Hatcher's in deep now. That's on his backhand towards the net. Mono centering speed. There's Madonna, and he missed it on the backhand. Hatcher able to keep in. Sauer, good physical defenseman for Anaheim, doing a number on Morrow. Back behind the net, here's Madonna. Morrow takes it, shot it off Madonna, trying to get it back to him. Here's Hatcher, away from Korea. Good effort by the referee to leap over that puck. Steven Walker. Madonna on it. Young, the one-timer. Ruchin blocked it. It was in his skates. Niedermeyer's got a stick on Young. Now the shot is blocked, and Ruchin will just clear. Turco's out to play it. Away from a charging Korea. Hatchett off the boards, and Anaheim will get possession.
All that work and no shots, though. That's a lot of perimeter work, a lot of work down low. Ducks are really doing a good job blocking shots. They've got 14 blocked shots in this game.
Matt Tkachuk up ahead to center, turned back over. The Stars look to regroup in their own end. Philippe Boucher will shoot it around all the way down. No doubt about this. Icing will be called.
He just couldn't get it up high enough. What a save, though, by Turco.
She stopped like Niedermeyer had 3 points in that series against Detroit, tying for the team lead. Kapanen is pinned to the boards. Oates deep in his own end. Turned it over. Here's Lettinen. Cycles it down deeper. There's Alfdahl. Hit by Ozilinch. Kapanen in. Dahlin able to come away. Alfdahl has tremendous reach. Dahlin backhand. Forehand shot blocked by Ozilinch. Loose puck. Still there's no whistle. Finally, there it is. With a couple of ducks on top of Alfdahl.
Oh, Isidore was taken down by Sikora at the end of that play. Dahlin did a nice job of using his strength coming around the net. Well, I thought Ozilinch was pretty tough as well on the puck. Ozilinch was a plus player in the series against Detroit, a plus four. There's a little wraparound play. There's Ozilinch on the ice, sprawling, playing a little street hockey goaltending right there. And then puck comes in and he pushes it right back to his goaltender. Right back underneath the pad, or to the pad, of Jean-Sébastien Giguère, who's the first goalie to win his first four playoff games since 1986 when Mike Vernon did it in Calgary.
Face off to the right of Giguère.
Before losing to Patrick Waugh and the Canadiens in the finals.
Mark Chouinard was tossed out. Dallas wins the faceoff. Zubov has it blocked by Chouinard. Race for the puck. And Zubov will get there first. Prague will open up the scoring of this Western Conference semifinal series. Seems like a long time ago. 13:08 of the first period. Prague, Hatcher, Niedermeyer, Ruchin, and Arnett. Your five goal scorers in this game. 3-2 Anaheim. 5.5 to play. Third period. As always, we say regulation time.
Yeah.
Perfect in the playoffs. Last season, they had the most one-goal losses in the league, 21 of them. And they're trying to protect a one-goal lead here with 5:20 to play in the third period.
Yeah, 4-0 in that opening round series against the Detroit Red Wings.
They didn't blow them out, did they?
Every game's a close game. Detroit played well. They created a lot of unbelievable chances. They created more scoring chances than Dallas has so far in this hockey game. Better scoring chances.
Seems that just every game in that series was about Giguère. And should this score hold up in this kind of tempo, I don't think this win will so much be about Giguère. This would be much more, I think, of a team effort. Niedermeyer, Rockets won. And the save there by Turco.
Keep in mind, Turco's making some pretty good saves, but I agree with you. The Ducks have had 27 shots. The Stars have had 19.
Picked off. Here's Kapanen off the turnover from the angle. Maybe off the shoulder of Giguère. Ozilinch are wrapping around. Too hard for Carney. Sikora on the far side got a piece. Icing will be called.
So it is a dead issue right now until the NHL does some tweaking with certain rules and regulations. And they will next year in terms of pads. But these goalies are smart, boy. They try every which way they can, every little angle to get an edge.
The guy who brought it up first publicly, I believe, is a guy not even playing tonight. That's Claude Lemieux of Dallas, who was a healthy scratch. How deep do you have to be to have Claude Lemieux as a healthy scratch? That really says something, again, about the depth of the Dallas Stars. Shot saved. Jaguar will hang on, and there's no rebound. And another good forward's going to come out of the lineup whenever Billy Guerin comes back.
Yeah, you're right about that. So there's depth there from their point of view. And also, you were mentioning before about what happened in that last series, and Ruchin the hero, scoring that goal in overtime after Sergei Fedorov had tied it with a couple of minutes left in the game. And here tonight, look at where he is. Similar spot, huh? Right in the slot again. The big Steve Ruchin, who has battled more adversity health-wise than many, many players of the National Hockey League. And he's hanging in there, having a real good, solid year after only playing 38 games last year.
First time in his career, Pang, he played all 82 games this season. So important to Anaheim.
Good stuff for a very underrated performer.
Here's Hatcher now. Working on Paulson. Those two have gotten together a couple times in the game. And by the way, they're still together in an Anaheim corner.
And look for the D to be very aggressive in terms of Dallas's play. Obviously, you saw Hatcher way up there. They're down by one with only 3 minutes to go.
Here's Barnes now, cutting to the middle of the ice. They're onside. Barnes will let it go, and it goes deflected. Back behind the net now. Loose puck side of the Barnes got across. Turgeon walking at it. Not in, no goal. Nick Magoo emphatically saying no goal. And Magoo was on that side of the net. And in proper position. Off the draw, Niedermeyer did not get it out. Deflected it in! It's a 3-3 hockey game with 2:47 left in the third.
Mora was in front of the net. And it looked like he got it after Mike Madonna and Niedermeyer battled. The Anaheim Mighty Ducks had possession. Niedermeyer fired it up the boards. Oh, boy. Oh, Jaguar must have taken his eye off it just for a split second. After Morrow tipped it, innocent-looking shot from the point. Morrow gets the shaft of his stick on it, changes directions. And Jaguar gave it a little wave, but it all started with Niedermeyer. He had the puck, he had possession. Very similar to the first goal that the Ducks scored when the Dallas Stars popped the puck up.
And so for as lackluster as Dallas had played tonight, they were in a tie hockey game with 2.5 left. And things really start to get interesting right about now. Turco telling Hatcher no icing will be called. He turns it over to Ruchin. Loose puck in front. LeClaire shot. And Turco looked behind him, but he's got the puck. Nearly a devastating giveaway in the Dallas end. 17-13 is the time of the tying goal. Brandon Morrow, who had a very good first round but didn't score a goal. He's got a goal here. Third playoff goal of his career. A little bit of the lone assist on the shot. And Morrow, the read deflection. 3-3, under 2 minutes of play. Ruslan Soleil. This is what it's all about. The Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN, presented by Nextel. And the crowd back into it, maybe for the first time in the night. Sauer back on the bouncing puck. Turned over to Lettinen. On his backhand now. Back behind it. Kevin will score! And Jaguar flashed out the glove. What a save on Yuri Lettinen. Cool and calm. How do you do? Face off to the left of Jaguar. Dahlin got to it as he was dragged down, able to keep it inside the zone. Nifty moves by Barnes, who's had a very good game with not a whole lot to show for it on the stat sheet. Turco, leave it for his defense. Wrapped up the boards on the near side. Airs off Dahlin, he'll shoot in. Dallas is taking over here in the third. Dahlin away from Havlid. Shelberg on the far side. He was fortunate Boucher could not keep in there. Final minute of play, regulation time. Here's Boucher. He'll backhand in softly. Ozolin shall go back for it. Mighty Ducks have blown a 3-1 lead, a lead they had in the latter stages of the second period. All the way down the ice. Will that be a critical icing call? Zubov back for the touch. 41 seconds left in regulation. And the faceoff deep upcoming in the Anaheim zone.
Yeah, the only option there because of Dave Tippett's neutral zone play was up the boards. Just a little too hard for the Anaheim Mighty Duck. You want to softly put it up the board so it doesn't go all the way down. 41 seconds left, and we've got a huge, huge situation here. The Anaheim Mighty Ducks have two centermen. Madonna throws a left-hand shot, so he can pull it back to his strong side with some help right here from Brendan Morrow. But again, the Ducks have got Niedermeyer. He loses the draw.
Back to the point. Zubov shot blocked. Carney out ahead for Sammy Paulson. Paulson will shoot in. Final half minute. Here's Hatcher on it now. Morrow at center. Got it across the line and in deep. Ruslan Soleil will back and chase Morrow first. On it and takes Soleil out of a big way on the crowd roars. Final 12 seconds. Letnin. Madonna's shot blocked by Carney. Loose puck. Madonna knocked down on the ice. Hatcher. Oh! Step into his man.
Oh!
Put Carlson down in a big way. And so regulation time ends with a flurry, and for the first time they're on their feet at the American Center here in Dallas. A sudden death overtime goal in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Simply mind-boggling. Off the faceoff. We're in overtime. Keith Carney to the touch. Icing called.
And that's a big advantage, as he mentioned. You got to keep things rolling. You can't wear out your big guns early.
Here's Harry Letton in the center ice across the red line and shoot in. Who's going to make the first mistake? Who'll make the first great play? Either way, it'll earn you a 1-0 lead in this best of seven series. Game two, Saturday afternoon, right back here. You'll see it on ABC. Zubov up the near side for Rob DeMille. DeMille, the nifty moves at center. Has Kapanen waiting for him to be onside. Kapanen gets it and shoots it wide. Far side, there's Hatcher. Side to that loose puck. Kapanen in front. Oh, still loose in front. And LeClaire to clear it out. Here's Sikora. His long shot is blockered aside by Turco. Zubov shoots to the corner. Just like they say, hey, no such thing as a dumb question. No such thing as a bad shot in sudden death overtime.
Never. Always put the puck on net. Never, never avoid that opportunity.
Turco plays it to Zubov. Off of Brendan Morrow. Has Madonna. Young couldn't handle. Carney can. Niedermeyer there. Two-line pass. Whistled down.
That's my puck. I've got that. If you let the man go and he's able to get the stick down and lift it up over your shoulder when you're expecting a loose puck down low, you're in a heck load of trouble.
Carney cross ice for Thomas. No stranger to overtime goals. Steve Thomas has 13 regular season overtime goals. That is an NHL record. Chistock touches it to Thomas. Tries to go across for Paulson. It'll be hammered on the boards by Boucher. Chopped that by Arne. Far side. Soleil nearly blew a tire. Stayed on his feet. Hops on Thomas and gets by him. Back behind the net. Here's Arne. Looking to move it out. He'll just lift out the backhander to center ice. Nozalinch in the back of the chase. He's pressured by Kirk Muller. Off the glass. Right while Dallas was changing.
Yep, both of
them. Here's Anaheim now and across the line. It's Chistock. Rubbed out by Robida. Taken away by Sikora now. Here's Sikora. Let's it go. Stick saved by Turco.
Sikora would be one of those guys. If I'm in the net, man, I'm worried when he's got the puck. Because he can fire it hard. High and from anywhere. And so it's a good curl up play by Sikora coming around the left faceoff circle.
Out at center now, back softly inside the Anaheim end. Niedermeyer able to push it across. Have we seen Paul Kariya yet in overtime?
Yeah.
LeClaire,
yep,
can't get there. And here's Madonna. And across the line. Good little back check by Rucci and knocked the puck off his stick. Here's Morrow. Way open up for a tip. And it never got it away. Back to the point. Matvichuk. Quick shot through traffic. And it kicked to the right as Jaguar
good job in front of the net. Good screen.
Here's Haviland in. Off for LeClaire. Let it go. Missed the mark. Far side. Lucian will get there. The overtime hero in game four. Clinching goal in their series sweep of mighty Detroit. Here's Haviland. Tried to get it in deep and couldn't. Kapanen enforced him. LeClaire. They're at the late offside and they will whistle it down.
Jaguar's leaning back. He's got the paddle of his stick along the ice. Just hoping that it's going to be a low one if it comes at all.
Here's Philippe Boucher. By far the best chance so far. 4 minutes in a sudden death overtime. Out of center. Pass picked off. There's Correa near boards. Nearly turned it over. Correa took a punch to the face, I think, from DeMaio. And a penalty is coming up.
Meantime, DeMaio's smoking the captain, Paul Correa.
Power play for the Dallas Stars in sudden death overtime. Soleil hooking at 4:12. Only the Stars' third power play of the hockey game. Here's Zubac now. Zubac will get the return feed. And look to shoot it around. Far side, Madonna was there with Shelberg. Sauer comes over, he's pinned by Young. Lettinen in there as well, hit by Carney. Rolls up the near side for Zubac. Lettinen let it go to Madonna. Young is hanging in a high slot. Back to the point, Zubac, good play. Gets a pick, Zubac holding. Makes the feed to Madonna, couldn't hit it. Blind centering pass, Shelberg. And he's fortunate the backhander was able to clear.
Mike was a little impatient there, going to his backhand and trying to force something up the middle.
Here's Madonna, Young towards the front of the net. Mike tries to make the move. They'll go back to the point for Zubac. Swings it across the door. Lets it go through traffic. It was blocked, I think, by Sauer. And never made it on goal. The Ducks are clear. 55 seconds left. On the man advantage and sudden death overtime from Dallas. Zubac across to Hatcher. Paulson will chase in. They've been going at it all night. Paulson rubs him out. Niedermeyer able to clear. Out to center.
They want to see what Paulson's all about. You know, they watched him have a very successful series against Detroit. They want to eliminate him physically.
I've seen Paulson initiate himself on Hatcher.
No, I agree with you.
It's the two-way street in that regard.
He's showing a lot. He really is. And he got smoked at the end of that period, at end of regulation, by the forearm of Hatcher.
Haviland. He's out man in the corner. Back to the point. Boucher will keep in. 10 seconds left of power play time. Loose puck. Hand pass, which is okay in your own zone. And that will just about do it for the power play. And the Mighty Ducks survive.
The Ukraine native Vishnevsky does a nice job in front of his net.
Dallas gets no shot to the man advantage. Lettman's onside. Let it go. Correa being tied up in the corner. Correa able to come away. Now he's hooked. You have to think Dallas would have to be very, very careful now that any questionable call might go against them in terms of a penalty and a power play for Anaheim. Sent to the corner. Here's DeMaio from the angle. Lets it go. And Jaguar is hugging the post and with a star nowhere even near him. He does get the fortunate whistle. 44 on 44 on the faceoff. And Arnett's able to beat Niedermeyer, but the Ducks get possession. At center, LeClaire is hammered. Niedermeyer's got the long reach, able to use it. Matvichuk, a big shoulder hit on him. Soleil, the defenseman, is in deep for Anaheim. LeClaire along the boards. Frog did a good job coming back to protect that point vacated by Soleil. That shot is ripped over the net. Stars will get to it. Kept in by Haviland at the point. Matvichuk ties up LeClaire. Good board work by LeClaire, who's had a strong hockey game for the Ducks. Barnes will get to it and slap it down the ice. And icing will be called. Slay back for the touch ahead of Muller. Prior to that Lucian goal, turned over by Hatcher. Correa on it. Morrow able to clear. Prior to that goal that clinched that series against Detroit, Correa was the only one in franchise history that scored an overtime game winner in the playoffs. And here he is. 3-on-2. Correa rolling on him. Now Corral to try to center. And Turco was able to deflect it away from Lucian. Dallas trying to come back out now. Here's Carney. soft pass in the skates of Ruchin. Able to push it ahead now. Here's Sikora, lets it go. Easy stick save for Turco. Korea tied up and swung around. And the Anaheim bench is standing up looking for a penalty call there. Madonna spilled down, no call. Hatcher will let it go. It's deflected into the netting.
So, both sides.
Kudos to Madonna, though, for staying on his feet.
Got to do it.
Whenever possible.
I guess that's the old argument they had, though. When we went down, we used to get a hooking call against us.
Yep. You'd like that in sudden death overtime in the playoffs. Just onside is Chistoff now. There's Soleil. Again, the defense been empty. Loose puck back to the point. And Paulson let it go off the glass. Soleil down low. Here's Thomas. Finds Paulson. Paulson's still on it. Matt Tkachuk checking him. Soleil is run into by Matt Tkachuk. Dallas gets the puck because of the hit. And Havlin will go back and chase it. Nicholas Havlin crossed the red line and shoot in. Turco got a piece to slow it down. On jumps Amos. Robina went out of his way to play the body. And let his teammate take the puck. And it's flipped into the crowd.
And he can still fire the puck.
Off the draw, duck skip to it. They fake the pass back to the point to Osimhen. Niedermeyer and Sidor go to the court. It's chipped softly back behind the net. Stars get to it. DeMaio. Osimhen still able to keep it. And DeMaio able to get it. No spring. Lettinen on the far side. Yuri Lettinen. Fame on a shot. Backhander is tipped aside by Osimhen. Good job by Osimhen to get back into the play. Here's Boucher. He'll shoot it around. Back behind the net is Kapanen now. The centering feed is fanned on again. Boucher, quick shot to Jeffy. Stayed by Jaguar and the rebound poked wide by Kapanen. Wrapped around the board to Strange bouncing out of the zone. Wow. Close call for the Mighty Ducks.
Oh, boy. I think the defenseman, Ozilic, might have helped him out there. I think he was in a little trouble. He had to flare open the pad. He was wide open underneath.
I would think Ozilic should be a player to watch in this overtime. In all three zones, he could make a play leading to a goal. Shot! Turco! Loose puck side on it to the Stars. Ruchin had the opportunity to be the hero again. And Turco went post to post on. Here's Zubov now. Off for Young. Chipped it into the corner. Havlin on the far side. Sikora got a stick on it. And then you're going to say it went into the Dallas bench and then came back on the ice.
Oh, my.
A couple of chances here in the last couple minutes.
Oh, has this been good? Good saves. That's for darn sure. Good saves.
Soleil off the draw and off the boards and out of the zone. Here's Chistoff. Well, Matt Tkachuk lost his edge and went down, but Chistoff couldn't take advantage. And Paulson is back for it. Ozilic shoots it across. Now the Ducks from behind their own net. Chistoff couldn't handle that. Robina for Dallas. Off the stick of Barnes. Here's Audit. Center in front through Ulf Dahlin. Back to the point. Shot block. Let's see if the Ducks can break. Two on two. Thomas has found some speed. He was crushed into the boards by Robina as he adjusts his helmet. Here's Barnes now. Off for Dahlin. Soleil will step into him. Everybody finishing their hits here in sudden death overtime. 8.5 left in this first overtime period. Back behind the net. Chistoff's got time. And he'll drop it in even deeper, and Soleil will carry.
Well, the reason Thomas had speed, too, because he blocked the shot. He followed his man around the net. Then he came out in front. That's going to be an icing call. Face off at the Ducks.
Off the faceoff, Ducks get to it with Carney. Korea didn't have a chance with it, whacked it center. DeMaio gets to it there. Cross the line and holds. Towards the net, Lettinen was headed in that direction. He's cut off by Havlin. Still center, side of the net, and Jaguar has it. Draw to the right of Jaguar. Clean win by Dallas. Sidor just able to keep it in. Puck worked up the near boards. The battle for it there. Young trying to keep it in. Niedermeyer trying to pump it out. Niedermeyer wins that battle. Rob Niedermeyer has the only special teams goal in the game. A shorthanded tally. The other five were all at even strength.
And and guys are giving, you know, they're giving the opponent the extra little tug now. They're getting little hooks, little holds, so you're really going to have to move your feet and have short shifts because it's going to be draining and very taxing on these players.
Again, we did have a penalty in overtime. Soleil went for a hook at 4-12. Well, that's an old story now. Madonna, Morrow, behind the back centering pass, did not connect. And this will go for icing. Darian Hatcher back. 7:04 left in period number four.
Dallas Stars making that adjustment. Good cross ice dump to the weak side of the ice and go retrieve.
Off the draw, Stars get to it. Here's Zubov now. Zubov from the point. It was blocked by Correa. Here's Anaheim, 3-on-2. Oates leading the rush. Gets it across. Paulson shot. Saved by Turco. Rebound loose. And it's Dallas the other way. Hell, a full flex 3-on-2. What a hit by Soleil to stand up his man at center ice.
Not just any man. Big Jason Arnott, too. That was a good hit. Very good hit by the tough Soleil.
Up the far side, Correa will backhand it out. Sorry, did you just drop a plethora on me, Payne?
I did. That's the Robert Borden High School.
I had to think about that.
That's to be in Ontario.
I thought that's what you said, but I just had to double check. Here's Kapanen. They're onside. That was close. Barnes rocket shot, and the glove of Jagr says no.
The ones he can't stop are the ones that are bouncing around on the deflection by Morrow. They're the toughest ones. The ones that come off sticks when you're seeing it like Jagr, that's when he sees it right from the stick right into his glove. He's making some great glove saves.
Frog and Dahlin going to the glass. Loose puck to Anaheim. It's knocked down at center by Robida. They'll get to it and shoot it around. Carney will take a look. Loses to Dahlin. That shot from the angle was deflected and off the glass. And it's kicked out the center.
See, they're trying that play again. He'll shoot it off the shaft of the stick and see if it can go in the net trick.
Practice that, I know. Tough to do. Carney worked it up the boards. Rubin up is checked as he puts it right back in. And LeClaire has off for Prague at center ice. Baseball tonight. The award-winning baseball tonight. Congratulations to Carl and everybody back in the studio. As John pointed out, won that Sports Emmy Award.
Look at this classic breakout here. Madonna's got speed on the weak side. Keep your eye on 9.
Here's Soleil moving it away. Anyway, baseball tonight is gone for now. SportsCenter will be coming up next. As soon as we finish here in Dallas, of course, we're not sure, quite frankly, when that will be.
They get paid for that show?
Just like we get paid double for double overtime. Doesn't work that way, does it? Hey, you and I would be rich if that was the case. Here's Soleil, the touch. Morrow put a stick on him. Icing his call. 4:44 left in this first overtime period.
From Yuri Lehtinen from the bench.
Off the draw, Hatcher has time to look around, works it up the near side. Tamayo couldn't do anything with it. Off of Ocean Pad, Haviland will keep in. Zubov will swing it around. There's Correa. Got to it first, but couldn't do anything with it. And Vitali Vishnevsky will play it back at their blue line.
And Mike Babcock's putting a line combination of Oates, Correa, and Steve Thomas together, seeing if there can be a little magic with the creative Oates. And he's got a couple of shooters on either side.
Tipped out by Correa. Too far. Kapanen back for the touch. 4:09 left in this overtime. At least the upside is these are two well-rested teams. It's not as if they played a 7-game series and ending a couple of nights ago.
No. No, you are right about that. It's not like they're going back-to-back like we saw in 6 and 7. 39 goals in 146 wow. games. And it's all about helpers for Adam. I mean, it's all about dishing the puck. He's really, truly is one of the most creative centermen that have ever played the game. And his assist totals will tell you that. He often looks off players and finds the open man. He's one of the great box lacrosse players, indoor lacrosse players that we've seen in Ontario.
Really?
Once had 29 points in one game. Still a record.
That's good.
I think it's still a record. It was a record of my old notes.
Oates, for his career, has averaged a point a game against the Stars franchise. It's Minnesota inbounds. Back to the point. Quick shot. Stop blocker to side. Jagr has it popped up in the air. And then was shot into the corner. G-Stop couldn't knock it down. Robita will get it across. Robita gets the return feet. Up the near side, here's Stu Barnes. Sauer came over to cut him off. That allows Pierre Turgeon. Turgeon figures to be fairly fresh, although it's his first game back. Hasn't played normal Turgeon minutes. Sidor rushing in. Sauer went over to cut him off. Ozilinch will have a second to take a look and a breather. Tries to reverse the flow away from Young. Ozilinch gets it back. Coughs it up to Morrow. Morrow to Madonna. Boucher just inside the zone. Shoots to the corner. Back to Sidor through traffic. Went wide of the net. Up the near side. Madonna able to hold in momentarily. Niedermeyer off the shin pad of Young. And right to Jaguar. Ducks get to it and they'll flip in. Boucher will move it ahead. Pass picked off at center. Here's Rutschen. Trying to make the move to the blue line on the wrong side. Rutschen. Oh, it was deflected off Boucher. The defenseman went down. Shelberg for Anaheim. He's barked. Rutschen has it now. Quick shot. LeClair. And a glove save by Marty Turco.
Good glove save.
Oates lost the draw to Barnes, who kicked it deeper. Hatcher wraps it around the boards. Soleil came over to pinch, took his man. Good play by Sakura to protect for him. Turned over at center. Here's Oates again. Oates will shoot it. And Zubov will take it. Wrapped around the boards. Two on two along the wall. Zubov will get to it again. Correa on him. Still on him. Good strength by Zubov to still make the play.
A good tenacity, though, by Corita to stay with him and try to create a turnover. He was looking for a little help, I think, from another one of his forwards to come over.
Corita gets the center and backhands in. It's delayed offside, and they will whistle it down.
Any shot on your net could eventually go in, so whatever you do, make an effort to block it at some particular point before it gets there.
Niedermeyer is surrounded by white sweaters. Robita will swing it across from Matt Tkachuk, finds Arty. Off for Barnes, couldn't handle. Ducks will take over with Sauer. Push back the other way. There's Correa. Hit by Arnett and sent down. And softly into the Dallas end. And Matt Tkachuk will go for it. Niedermeyer looks to tie him up. And does a good job. Although it's backhanded out for Dahlin. And all the way down. Rolls softly. They wave off the icing at the very last second.
Boy.
LeClair. Get a second crack at it. Final minute of play in our first sudden death overtime period. Turned over, but Young able to get to the loose puck.
That's two situations where the first forechecker for Anaheim's team is getting in on the Dallas defense. So if you think they're extremely passive, you're right if there's a controlled breakout. But when there's a race for the puck, the Anaheim forecheckers do an excellent job of putting backside pressure, putting pressure on the defensemen of Dallas. They're looking for that one turnover.
Soleil was whacked at by behind. 21 seconds, race for the puck. Hatcher with Rutschen on him. Rutschen wins the battle. Trying to center, does center. Shelberg was there. Face off to the left of Turco. It's won by Anaheim. Soleil drops it in deeper. Madonna on it now. Centering feed through everybody. But Carney lets it go. Barnes blocked it. Loose puck. Madonna takes a look at the clock. He's hit there by Schwenard, and that will do it. Game one, Western Conference semifinals. 3-3, the Mighty Ducks in the visiting purple and the Stars in the home white. They have battled valiantly throughout the night. And who knows how much longer it will continue. Turned over. Here's Niedermeyer. Down low Rutschen. Madonna, tremendous back check to break up that centering pass.
Boy, he's a great two-way player, isn't he? He cares about his own zone, that's for sure. You're right about that. But it also came again on another turnover. I know that's going to happen. And it's a game of hockey, and it's a game of mistakes. But in your own zone, boy, you can ill afford to do it. It's one of them is going to be magnified.
And when fatigue starts to kick in, shot through traffic, if there are going to be more turnovers. Tip, save, loose puck. Morrow had a couple of bats at it on the shot by Kapanen. Rutschen trying to force it out. Couldn't. Haviland the other way for Anaheim. Up for Sakura. Oh. Makes the move, but the puck went ahead of him. And Boucher was there for Sidor, who's got a lane. Here's Darryl Sidor. Rockets one around. Here are the Stars, set up pretty well here, center and feed. And it was deflected wide of the net. Lettman got the shot away. DeMaio and Kapanen fill out this forward line. Vitali Vasilevskiy will get to it for Anaheim. He's being tugged at with one arm, able to push it ahead to Thomas. Shoots to the corner. Sidor off for Boucher. LeClair can't get to it. Off Dahlin can. Dahlin off the boards. Lettman will go for a change. Dahlin will chase Ruslan Soley. Vasilevskiy trying to put it hard off the boards. Instead, wound up being decked to the ice. Soley was going to go behind the net, and then he saw the player in front. Hey, I better get that Stu Barnes guy.
Yeah, good play there. It all started with good forecheck there by Elf Dahlin. That caused this little bit of pressure inside the Anaheim Mighty Ducks zone. And also good communication, too, by the defenseman of Dallas getting out of their own zone with Sidor tapping the stick on the ice for the puck.
Sauer back for the touch.
To tie it at 3.
Off the faceoff, it's punched out to center ice. And wrapped around the board. Too far for Roman to get to it. Ducks able to keep in. Turco will kick it to the side. Morrow, a little tricky play through his legs to get out of the zone. There's Keith Carney, who played 44 minutes in that triple overtime game in game one against Detroit, won by Korea. He's played 35 minutes so far as we hit our second sudden death overtime period. Saturday will be here before these teams know it for game two of the series.
Yeah, sure will.
That day off in between with the afternoon game on Saturday is disappearing.
Oh, nice play by Turco. See that spin around move up play? Looked like he was going behind the net. He went right in front to Hatcher.
Soley will wrap it around himself and all the way down. They'll wave off the icing.
Waved off early by the linesman. There was a Dallas start making a line change. It went right by his skate.
Kapanen, take the tape. Nice pass from Zubon. Off to Dahlin. Soleil will wrap it around on the far side. Niedermeyer goes over to cut off Zubov. Oates is in there as well, and he's able to backhand that.
Zubov entered in this period, has played 38 minutes. That's the most of any player on the Dallas Stars, and I believe it's the most of any player on the ice. Yes, it is.
Dahlin trying to poke it ahead and does. There's Arden. Arden centered nearly off Ozil inching in. Chopped that. Soleil working on Arden. Centering pass again. And Ozil couldn't handle that play as it's pumped out to center ice. This will be icing, assuming Anaheim touches first. And they just do. Krog will take this draw. He's beaten on it, though, by Barnes. Wrapped around the near side. There's Muller at center. He's checked. Puck inside the Anaheim zone. Barnes trying to force it in. Krog the other way. Jason Krog started the scoring a long time ago. Here's Krog. He's onside. Backhands one. And Turco will hang on. Jason Krog scored at 13:08 of the first period to give Anaheim the 1-0 lead. Don't forget, whenever this game finishes, SportsCenter is coming up. Reese Davis, John Anderson are standing by, and I've been in that position. I do mean standing by.
Yeah, we are in 2 overtimes right now, and you and I were a part of 5 overtimes, and I know they had to stay for an awful long time in Studio A.
Yep. This game could end with a blink of the eye in 30 seconds from the start of SportsCenter. So stay tuned for that. Keep an eye on the scores and some details on the bottom line. Chopped at loose puck. Young with a rolling puck, and he hammered it wide. Kept it on the far side. Matano for Young again. Saves again. Well out of his crease to make the stop. Looking sharp, cutting down the angle.
That is just such a solid push by Giguere. Keep in mind, he's real strong. I talked to the strength and conditioning coach today, and he talked about the power in his legs. So doesn't look like he's going to weaken as this game goes on. That was a great read by Giguere to get out there.
6'1", 199 pounds. That's without his rather lofty equipment. That shot from Haviland is blocked by Zubov. Morrow takes his man out in a big way. Korea's chasing, can't get there. Very close to too many men on the ice, and that change by Anaheim. Soleil, somehow they're onside. Loose puck to the middle. Bodies go flying, but it's Kapanen the other way. Able to head man for Lettman. Lets it go, the save. And Giguere will hang on.
believe it was Morrow driving hard to the net.
Oates got enough out of the zone.
It was DeMaio, excuse me.
Boucher far side. I knew that's what you meant, Penny. Rosalich, checked by Barnes. Soleil in there. Rolls around the far side for Niedermeyer. We've had five shots taken so far in this second overtime. Dallas has four of the five. Sidor on it for the Stars. Back shot tipped in. Jaguar for Rosalich. Hit by Arden. Sidor. Long wall. Rosalich will get plenty of time. Got a bit of a screen from the referee that could do there. Now reverse. Dangerous play by Rosalich. Works out for now. Here's Peter Sikora. Gives it off to Niedermeyer. Had a step. Crashes into Sikora. Back behind the net. Robita for Dallas. And the headman pass. Again, Krog jumping onto the ice. Nearly touched the puck. Yeah.
Those are the little things, the little details you have to be so sharp on the bench. Communication's got to be good.
Here's Korean across the line. They're offside.
And you really know the havoc and the communication and they're yelling and screaming and how tired you get as the game goes on as well. It's important for guys that aren't playing to keep everybody sharp and supporting and doing whatever it takes.
LeClaire the other way. This pass too far. One of the very famous too many men on the ice calls in playoff history, the Bruins and Canadians.
Absolutely, Don Cherry.
1978. Cost Boston. 7 minutes in the double overtime.
Let's see if Madonna stays on the ice. And before they go for a line change, Dave Tippett's got the last change. Yes, Madonna does stay on the ice. And he was looking to see if Carney went off. And yes, a good non-play thereby. So Madonna's on there. Look for them to make a quick change just to get Carney on the ice.
Yep.
Familiarity. Watch for Vishnevsky. He's going to go right off the ice.
Great job, Hanger. Great job. Vishnevsky race to the bench. Carney right back on. Here's Madonna now. Shoots it across. And the Stars look to come up. It's tipped off Carney. Jaguar will play it. Off for Havlik. Turned over to Young. That shot is blocked. Loose puck. Here's Madonna. Save Jaguar. And the rebound hammered wide by Morrow. Young tying up his man at the point. Shot blocked, and it just clears out to center.
That's a heck of a shift by Carney. He looks like he's laboring. He's going to go off. What a save by Jaguar on the wicked snapshot by Mike Madonna, trying to go high, but Jaguar didn't bite on it.
Here's Madonna. This pass is broken up by Chistov. Off for Thomas, the master of the regular season overtime goal. Thomas makes the nifty move, but it doesn't result in much. Madonna, what a pass, tape to tape. Able to connect with DeMaio. He's checked, we go the other way. Thomas has it, trying to get Dallas in a change. Nothing doing. And it's pumped back out to center ice, and Sauer has it. Works it over across. Oh, Ozelinch just blew a tire and fell down, and just had enough composure to push it ahead. Off of Ozelinch now. Lettman trying to race through. Can't. Hatcher thought about going for it. Had to drop back. On Thomas. Onside. Here's Paulson. And Paulson made the shift to his left shoebox. Got a piece of it with his stick and took him down. Hatcher the other way. Out at center. Lettman got enough to get it in deep. Ruslan's legs. Been a ton of time. Off LeClaire and out to center ice. Oates on the forecheck. Can't get there in time. Fly ball center field. Ruslan Soleil's got it. Off for Oates. Shot around by Sikora. LeClaire will get there first, but Barnes is on it for Dallas, and he's able to knock it out the center. Arnett's got a step. Soleil got there and banged it off the boards. Sent back in. Delayed offside. No reason to delay it. They whistle it down. Nearly halfway through our second sudden death overtime period.
He labored going off.
Matt Tkachuk will shoot it around. Soleil on Barnes. Dolan behind the net is crunched. Shots are 8-2 Dallas. 8-2 Dallas here in the second overtime. Dolan behind the net. Soleil will get to it. Went for the body instead of the puck. And now is a chance to get the puck. And Robita will drop back. Off from Matt Tkachuk. Dropped down by Dolan. Inside the Anaheim end. Matt Tkachuk comes over to protect. It's force deeper. Gaguerre will come out and reverse it up the near side for Carney. He's whacked by Arne. Out ahead is Schwinnard. Schwinnard avoided the hit, got it in deep. No icing. Turco will leave it there for his defense. Ducks will get a wholesale change.
Take a look at this control breakout here by Dallas. O'Donnell takes charge.
Here's Morrow. Nice pass. Boy, is that a set play exactly? Young back in. Oh, feed for Madonna. And the Ducks look to break it the other way. Here's Rucci and Niedermeyer. They're onside. Niedermeyer will curl back. Look to go back to the point. Young saw that was going to happen. Morrow gets to it. And he'll backhand it down the ice. Jaguar has to play it away from Madonna. Korea trying to do something. Rucci trying to force Hatchett. Zubov on it there. Here's Young. They're onside. Young is belted there by Sauer as the puck went out of play. That's all coming up on SportsCenter. Reese Davis, John Anderson, not standing by there, sitting by, and rather patiently, I'm sure. Enjoying the action as you are. You're the head coaches. Have you canceled practice yet tomorrow, Tony? With all this extra skating. Here's DeMaio. Circle. Save. Jaguar.
I'm hoping it's like you're golfing.
Here's T-Stop the other way. He'll shoot it around. Got anybody special in your foursome tomorrow, Pena?
I think what you've got to think about, though. Hang on to my thought for a second. You've got to think about IV between periods, replenishing your fluids, get some carbs back in your body, get something in that body, energy-wise.
Here's Philippe Boucher with some energy, looking for the tip shot. Creative play, looking for DeMaio, but he couldn't get the stick on. Matt Tkachuk is back for it. Here's Madonna. He's got a step. Madonna lets it go. Pass it. Rebound. Morrow couldn't get there. And he goes crashing into the goalpost.
Good non-call by the official, I think.
Hatcher slaps it around. Carney on the far side. Back behind the net. Haviland will go to it. Niedermeyer at center ice. And it's sent softly in. Korea and Zubov go for it. Zubov able to make the play. We did have a penalty in overtime. Ruslan Soleil at 4:12 of the first overtime for hooking. And Dallas unable to score on their power play. The only power play chance by either team in sudden death overtime. Coming up on 7.5 left. Turco might have gotten the stick up high on LeClaire. Here's LeClaire in front. And it comes all the way out to center. 3-on-2. It's Madonna. Madonna for Young. Shot, save, rebound. Oh! And Jaguar has it. Couple of brilliant saves by John Sebastian Jaguar. Of the third period from Rovida was the tying goal. 7:20 left in this second sudden death overtime period. Here's Schwinnard. Can't get there. Turco able to stick it around him. Shots in this second overtime are 7-1 Dallas. Chances, rather. 7-1 Dallas. There's another one from Muller. Centered through everybody and clears. Kurt Muller tied for first among active players with 4 playoff overtime goals. No Sakic and Jaromir Jagr, the other players that have it.
And he hasn't had much ice time here in the overtimes. Those are the kind of guys to look for. Guys that haven't played, once they get a couple of seconds under their shift, then they're fresh bodies.
Here's Correa with a step. Hits the brakes. Looking for a tip shot as well from Sikora. He was tied up nicely. Turned over though at the point. And that shot is stopped by Turco as Hatcher squares to protect. It's game one in a period, and 6.5 minutes would be game one plus 2 periods. Game two, Saturday afternoon, right back here in Dallas. We'll see it on ABC. 6:21 left in this fifth period, second sudden death overtime period.
Yet another big face-off in front of Marty Turco. 200 feet away from that guy. Jaguar's had more action, and he's obviously gaining momentum. This is one of those things where you see a goalie make a couple of big saves, and then it goes down the other end on an odd man break. Happens a lot.
Here's Arnett, and across the line. He's on his backhand. Good job. He swept aside. Arnett, second chance! Outside the net! Here's Dollar now. checking on him. Sauer trying to pin Dahlin. Arden checks Paulson, and Dahlin was buried under the outside of the net. So Madonna goes against Rucci. Madonna wins it cleanly. Matt Tkachuk through traffic. And Jaguar the save. And Chouinard able to clear. Matt Tkachuk is back on it. Across the red line. High off the glass. Carney will go chase. Young can't get there because Carney can. Up the near side boards. Off of Matt Tkachuk. And because of that, won't go far enough for icing. 5.5 left. And there's double overtime, sudden death period. McDonough, what a pass date to take for Morrow. He couldn't handle. Carney was over there as well.
Sometimes he fires it just too hard.
And Carney again, slowly getting off the ice. Whistle down, two-line pass.
It seems to me like it's more significant for the home team here, the Dallas Stars, and this, you go triple overtime, and Anaheim Mighty Ducks walk away with a victory. It's reminiscent of something they've already done.
Here's LeClaire, centered in front. Boy, those plays are so close, your own guy can put it in. Havlid fanned, and is forced to bring it back to center.
Yeah, you don't want a guy with the happy hands right there. You know, you gotta have the calmness right there. Settle things down.
The happy hands. Juggle, 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 right? Here's DeMaio at center. They'll wrap it around. LeClaire took down one of the Stars. That's why the crowd reacted.
That was Lettinen.
Lettinen was taken down again from behind that time by Vishnevsky. Here's Thomas trying to cut in on Hatcher. Hatcher whacked at by Thomas. Lettinen trying to poke it in deep. Can't. Here's Ozilich. Long shot off the glass. Philippe Boucher. Hard off the wall and all the way down. This will go for icing as Sauer is back for the touch.
Whoa!
That shot
on his, by his own guy.
Off the face, near the side by Turkey. At center ice. 3:50 left. Taken away by Barnes. Little tug from behind by the veteran Thomas. Breaks up the play. Ducks shooting at Ozilich. Sidor just got it by Krog as he went across. Sports Center is coming up next. Just as soon as we are through. Play at center. Clubs go for a change. Here's Madonna for Young. Glove juggled. Little happy hands by the goaltender lunging at it, Jaguar.
Yeah, that might have glanced off a stick as well.
Here's Correa, the shift. And Matt Tkachuk blocked the shot. Rucci'll body his man. And it's out to center ice. Carney. Pass to the middle. Could not click with Niedermeyer. Here's Morrow with a step. He's cut off nicely by Havlid.
But it was still a shot on goal by Scott Young.
Hatcher will go back for it. Zubov makes the move. Nearly faked himself out and lost the puck at the red line. Oates will flip it away. Knocked down out of midair by Secor. Didn't know where it was. Lettinen does. DeMaio, the hack behind the net. Here's Lettinen now. Kapanen on it. Quick shot. Was blocked at the defense by Lettinen. Lettinen got the shot away.
What a play by Adam Oates. Adam Oates stuck with him and then stopped the shot with a step.
Here's Vishnevsky in deep, the defenseman on Zubov. 1:51 away from triple overtime. Here's LeClaire. Zubov can't get to it. Dallas can. Hatcher gets it back. DeMaio will shoot it around. Crowd responding. Good night to be a babysitter. Get a couple extra hours overtime if you're at home with all these fans hanging around. Out to center, Carney. Cross to Soleil.
Yeah, Oslitz was on there, and he quickly went for a line change. Carney came out to join Soleil as the tandem on the blue line.
Young got a piece. Long shot from Carney is stopped. Turco for Boucher. Soleil has final 60 seconds now. Long shot by Soleil. We've seen those kinds go in sudden death over time. Yeah. Morrow tips it just briefly into the Anaheim zone. And right back out, Thomas. Soleil will jump on it. Softly into the Dallas end. Morrow finished his hit on Rucha, nearly put him on the Dallas bench. Chipped out at center. Loose puck there. Matt Tkachuk came over, got it in. Here's Arnett now with the reach, with the strength. Arnett behind the net for Kirk Muller. Hamlet on him. Poked away. Arnett to Barnes. Muller in front of the net. Here's Barnes. Gets a bit of a screen from Muller. Hamlet, good job with the reach to poke it away. Muller still on it to Barnes. Barnes take it down. Sauer over to help out. Puck along the wall. Still in, and now it comes clear. 3 seconds left. Here's Correa. Let's it go. Oh, that would have counted, my friends. But a glove save by Marty Turco. It's worth mentioning Jay Mullen directed both of those games, the 4 and 5 overtime games.
He's our director this evening.
John Norton, Chris Ebert both worked on both of those games as well. So it's in the air. Something special brewing here at the American Airlines Center in Dallas. We're in triple overtime in the Stanley Cup playoffs. He's going to make the mistake. And we opened to the first overtime saying, hey, might be a great play, might be a mistake.
Yep.
The odds are much better now that it'll be a mistake than a great play, I would think. Here's Hatcher now. Looking to move it ahead. The captain of the Stars lugs it off to Stu Barnes. Barnes got it to the center of the ice. Dahlin had the shot. Oselich has his pocket pick. Take it away by Dahlin. In front, chance for Barnes. Saved by Jaguar.
And obviously, Jaguar had a hard time tracking it down. He actually put his glove towards it, kind of like attacking it, and it went beyond his reach.
Sent into the Anaheim end. Sauer wraps it around off of Madonna, and that'll force it back deeper. Nick Magoo, the referee, attempts to get out of the way. And Sauer just backhands it down the ice. Never a bad play. A shot on goal, or just to get it out of your zone. Turned over at center. Here's Rucha. One-on-one. Rucha's shot, and it was deflected by the defenseman, and that made it even more difficult for Turco to hit him. Here's Carney able to keep it. What a play by Carney to Rucha for Sakura, and he couldn't get the shot away. Young has it. Off for Madonna, a sweeping pass at center. Carney, off for Thomas, taken away by Madonna at center. Madonna made the pass, and it was broken up by Carney. Quick stick away from Morrow.
That's a good play by Carney to hold the line, get your stick up there, close the gap. If he backs up, he's not able to poke that puck out beyond the blue line.
Kept in. DeMaio's shot was tipped by Lettinen right into the glove of Jaguar.
Interesting thing, as we talk about the equipment of Jean-Sébastien Jaguar, with the rules that are out there, his glove is actually smaller than the maximum size.
Interesting.
So he's got some couple of inches that he can go on,
so
right there with the glove.
Gives and takes, you know, doesn't it all even out after a while?
Yeah. It's very common. What you see on him is what you see with top junior goalies, college goalies. I think they'll do something about it. But isn't that interesting about all the things? He likes the glove a little smaller.
Roll it out through traffic. Sage again. Oh, puck in front. Still loose. And finally, Anaheim gets to it. That Niedermeyer had the chance in front. Whistle down offside at the Anaheim blue line. The first game of the Detroit series, won by Paul Kariya. They're 1-1, the Mighty Ducks are, in triple overtime. Pumped out to center. Here's Hatcher. Off for DeMaio. And shot in. Lettinen is first on it. Screen from Kapanen. Lettinen's backhander. DeMaio shot. Saved by Jaguar. Loose puck. DeMaio on it again, and he wristed it wide. Wow. I think DeMaio might be getting stronger. Here's Hatcher, wrist shot. Stuck before it made it on goal. Back behind the net is Oates. Hatcher will keep in. Another wrister through traffic. Kicks wide. And Sakura will pick it up for Anaheim. across the red line. He's 1-on-3, and he'll shoot in.
Another wonderful shift by that same line, Lehtinen, Kapanen, and DeMaio. DeMaio and Kapanen, little guys with quick feet, and they're buzzing in the offensive zone.
We are now in the longest overtime game in the history of the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim. We've just gone past game one of that triple overtime game against Detroit. Here's Philippe Boucher on the backhander. And the save, the defenseman was in deep. Jaguar made the stop. Here's Niedermeyer. It's a very strong game for the Mighty Ducks. Madonna the other way. Off for Shador. He's got some time and space. Shoots across for Philippe Boucher. Boucher rolls one into the corner. Two stars there. One duck. Young able to get it across. Morrow, the centering feed from Madonna. Here's Shador. Cross ice pass all the way across for Boucher. Saves Jaguar. Morrow would have been there for the rebound, but there wasn't.
A lot of hamstrings stretching with the heel of his blade on the ice.
Off the faceoff, Barnes nearly had a chance, but the Ducks come away. Triple overtime shots so far. 6-1 in favor of Dallas. But it only takes one. Off the board, Soleil kept in with his glove. Barnes got enough to get it out. Here's Mark Schwinnard at center for Anaheim. They're barely onside as they shoot in. Here's Harden. Feathers it through. Back to the point. Robita. Through traffic. Save! And Soleil took his man down in front. There are some rebounds to be had now. Some loose pucks in front of that Anaheim goal.
Yeah, but the key is there's bodies in front of Jaguar. There's no way that he can control the rebound. He can't see the shot.
Here's Lehtinen making the move. Lehtinen's in. Saves Jaguar. He's in the net.
Stars are taking it over offensively.
Here's Thomas. Can't get it.
Look out.
Here's a break. Lehtinen trying to cut in. Lehtinen makes the pass. It's DeMaio. Kick save. Jaguar with the right pad. Lehtinen on it again. This line is buzzing for Dallas. Here's DeMaio. Backhander in front. Save Jaguar. Ruchin and Madonna. Jaguar has already made 10 saves in this third overtime. Now we're only 5:40 in. Here's Madonna on his backhand now. Still has it. Cross for Hatcher. Lets it go. Saves Jaguar. Wow. Here's Madonna. It is all Dallas now. Blocker to side. Young the shot. Jaguar another save. Back to the point. Here's Zubov. Through traffic. Missed the net. Morrow punches Soleil to free himself. And then Morrow the big hit. Players spilled at the blue line. But it comes out to center. Madonna will glove it down from Hatcher and get it back to him. Set softly in. Jaguar working around the boards. Carney, the cross check, puts his man down and then wraps it out to center. This is now the third longest overtime game in Stars franchise history. Already the longest game in the history of the Mighty Ducks. Here's Ruchin. He'll shoot in. See the shots on goal to this point. Anaheim able to get through it at center. 12-1 as shots now in this third overtime. That continues on, set softly in.
Well, we know we've got the most energy bars and the most IV between periods because the Dallas Stars came out fresher with more jump and more urgency.
Muller will shoot in now. Havlid moves, going to be smashed. Arnett centering feed. Never got there. Muller on it. Bad for Arnett behind the net. Sweeping around in front. Nobody home for Dallas. And LeClair for Sakura. He'll chop it down. And Boucher's back. Hanger, how's the ice in triple overtime? Is that effective? Hold that thought. Give it a chance now. As it sent softly into the corner. Kapanen tried to make the play. Muller rubs out Osiewicz. Wow, that was close play at the blue line. Boucher will shoot it. Deflected out of play.
It stays pretty much the same. I think the more use the ice gets, I think the better the ice actually gets. So now I don't, you know, this time of year, this, you know, now we're midway through the period. I think as you get to the 6-minute mark, I think you've got to make the safe plays. You can't be too fancy inside both lines, both blue lines. I think you've got to be extremely careful and diligent in your thought process. Take the safety route. rather than the fancy dipsy doodle way.
Here's Lettman, drop pass, Kapanen, missed the shot. Robita, Kapanen, quick shot to Mayo. Man, if you got to pick somebody who's going to get the game winner for Dallas, looks like Rob DeMaio's thinking about it.
You got that right. I mean, he's the only thing I can say, though, is except for the one wraparound that went up high, the chances are all on the short side and not directly in front.
Here's Robita, in across the line, drops it off. Through the crease, Madonna couldn't get there. Chistov, take the Thomas, lets it go. And a hard shot, an arm save by Turco. Thomas jumps on that loose puck. Chistov and Sidor. Chistov, oh, buried by Morrow. And I got to think that hit in the first period, that hit in triple overtime's got to hurt more now.
What a hit. He caught Chistov off guard. Some of the Dallas Stars were talking about the Detroit series and saying that Chistov plays a lot with his head down, especially in the middle of the ice. And he said, well, we know that already. We saw him. He's a dipsy doodler. He can handle the puck. We're going to hit him when we get a chance. That's a good example.
You do that once against the Hatcher and Matvichuk, I imagine. And then you probably don't make that mistake again.
Yes, he is a brilliant talent.
Niedermeyer, Korea away. Rob Niedermeyer's in. Let it go. It was blocked. Korea. Ruchin kicked it off his skate. Nifty little setup there. Here's Korea. Magician with the puck, captain on captain. We thought we'd see him hooked up tonight, and there's an example. And Hatcher wins that battle, is able to clear the puck.
It's a tough battle for Korea to beat because Hatcher is so strong on his stick.
Flipped out to center. Here's Arnett's got a lane. Jason Arnett saved!
Oh,
Jaguar! And Barnes couldn't get there for the rebound. Onside, LeClaire dropped for Oates. And what an effort there. Arnett was down on the ice and still made the play to get it out of the zone. Here's Oates. Little drop pass. Sikora let it go. And a stick save by Turco.
Haven't seen much of Oates, have we, in this period?
Ozarich back behind the net. Shannon is... Oh! Great save, Turco. Back to the point, but still loose. It's tipped wide. Here's LeClaire. Sikora gets Oates trying to bury it and can't from the side of the net. Anaheim had a burst, and it's whistled down. Give you an idea how long this game has gone. Dallas had four shots on goal in the first period. Four, the entire first period. They've had 56, 5-0. Ducks have 44 shots, Dallas 54. And we play on past the midway point of triple overtime. Here's Keith Carney now. Cross ice pass, it's broken up. Here's Muller, drop pass. Muller gets a return feed, Madonna gave it back to him. Carney up the far side, here's Jason Krog. Krog will shoot to the corner and go for a change.
Krog's one of those players you gotta watch out for because he's a good skater and he's got a finishing touch as he showed on the first goal of the game.
He's under 40.
And he's under the age of 40.
Oliver is hit hard.
Man.
And Oliver is down.
We haven't seen Oliver much in this game. He went in there awkwardly. I mean, he is in a great deal of pain because the way his legs went into the boards.
As he gets off the ice, they're offside. Paulson brought it across. 8:33 left.
It's phenomenal. I gave it to him on the ice, although I thought of a million different things I was going to do with the puck. But I looked at him, saw him, and gave it to him. And was he excited?
Yeah, was eBay one of them?
Yeah.
Here's a chance, knocked away by Carney. How many times Keith Carney knocked away centering feeds tonight?
Yeah, I'm surprised that more of the big bodies at Dallas haven't taken the body on him. I mean, they know he's out on the ice all the time with Mike Madonna, and it's not just Keith Carney stopping Mike Madonna, but, you know, you get a chance to finish him off, certainly you'd want to do so.
Carney's kind of lean, and listen, it's 6'1", 217, and he's got to be worn down by now. Shot to the corner. Lettinen and LeClaire go there. There is Keith Carney. Nice pass by Carney.
Just a good position of player.
And the Ducks, wow, it was a pretty good breakout until somebody hopped off that Dallas bench. And nearly too many men on the ice. And that's what Anaheim's complaining about. It was a good-looking breakout, and then all of a sudden the odds got evened up. The Stars had an extra player. There's DeMaio. Shifts to the corner. On Ozilin. Here's Morrow. Kapanen, the third forward on this line. Morrow, Kapanen. back from Morrow, stepped into his man just enough to get at the hatchet. Floater towards the net, missed it. Carry him off the end boards, off the outside of the net as the fans behind the goal react. Loose puck to Dallas. Kapanen is hit by Ozilinch and sent flying. Korea trying to make something happen with the speed and can't. Here's Morrow's got to be at a gas, end of his shift. Still on his knees. What an effort by Morrow to try to make the play. 6.5 left in triple overtime. The puck into the Anaheim bench.
Mike Modano shift. Some of them are partial. You know, obviously,
Here's Turgeon off the turnover, trying to get it through to Arnett. Never made it across. Turgeon still has it. The crafty setup man, Pierre Turgeon. The shaking bait behind the net. We'll go back to the point. Philippe Boucher will rock it.
Oh!
Might have been tipped with a high stick, but it went wide anyway.
That was Arnett's stick.
Kept in momentarily, and then Anaheim will flip it out. Headman pass. Modano shot it in. Dolan is there for Modano. Barnes to the front of the net. He tried to go to Boucher. Some miscommunication. Boucher was cutting in off his point, and it sails down the ice and turf over play.
Keep your eye on Arnett. I mean, he is getting busy in front of that net.
Shot in now. Where does he go? I don't blame him. Here's Modano working the wall. Got Rucci draped all over. Thomas for Niedermeyer. Here's Niedermeyer now. Inside the circle, hits the brakes. Carney coming late. Shot. Safe. Rebound. It's in.
It's Rucci.
5:19 left in the triple overtime. And the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim win 4-3 and take a 1-0 lead in this best-of-7 Western Conference semifinal series. Wow.
Keep in mind,
they just announced the building. The play is under review.
It is under review. All goals are under review. They look at every one of the goals.
Wow. Play continues on. And how will the no-goal call affect the Mighty Ducks?
Oh. I don't know about that.
I agree.
I mean, if Thomas was there all alone and it nudges it off, but Robidoux got him hemmed in there. He's kind of pinned in there. You talk about a turn of events. The emotions, you talk about, they're celebrating.
Here's Lettinen with a burst of speed. Lettinen trying to cut in. Back to the point. Zubov down low. Here are the Stars, set up pretty well here. They've been given a second chance here in triple overtime. Save Jaguar. And it's clear at the center. Speaking of that no goal call that Buffalo wished for back in 99, this has now passed that game in terms of time. Second longest game in Dallas Stars history. Jaguar will kick it to the corner. Loose puck back behind the net. That was game 6 of the 99 finals, the cup clincher. With Brett Hull in the crease. That clinched the cup for the Stars over the Sabres in Buffalo. To this day, you still see signs in Buffalo. Even at Bills games, you say no goal. In long memories. Up for Barnes now. 3:50 left in triple overtime. Barnes had his stick lifted. Here's Chistov. Far side for Thomas. Let's go on the rolling puck. He was hit as he was coming across. Thomas on it again.
He wants it back.
Works it in deeper. Wrapped around the boards. Sauer on it. Pinned along the blue line. Thomas is held. Muller trying to one-touch it, and it's whistled down. A two-line pass. 3:25 left.
Game winner.
Each team still has a timeout remaining. I thought that'd be a pertinent fact here in triple overtime.
They've not had a timeout.
No, one of them. Neither team has used it. Used any.
That's an excellent point.
LeClaire was hit up high and then fired back with a punch to Hatcher. This would be a bad time to get called for a roughing minor. Go to the box by yourself. Here's Carney. Carney's been a horse. Here's Ruchin. Ruchin centers for Sikora and just missed.
Oh, what a play that was.
Here's Shelburne. Off for Soleil. Towards the net. Blocked down in traffic. Sikora and Hatchett go there. Zubov in as well. Shelburne forces it deeper. Shot from the angle. Loose puck off a skate of Hatchett. And then to Turco. 2:32 left in period number six.
That's one of those ones that ends up in the net because it glanced off the player and you're spreading your legs to one side and it can easily glance in between you. So that's a smart play on the far side. And there's an earlier chance here. Ruchin's pass. A little soft one over to Sikora. Sikora's trying to get beyond the very good backward skating Sergei Zubov. And it just had a little too much on it. He just had to float that a little bit more and Sikora would have had a good scoring chance.
And off the face, it comes all the way down softly into the Anaheim end. Ozilic calling for the puck and gets it from Soleil. Tipped in by Krog. Shelberg will chase Robita. Gets a screen from Matvichuk. And Robita able to move it away. In across the line. Here's DeMaio. Towards the net, hit the outside of the pipe. Lettinen hacking away at the side of the net. And we push it ahead to center. Now officially the longest game in Dallas Stars history. Batted at and back to center. Robita will get another crack. Minute 50 left. Oh, and Robita is shouldered by Ozilic and down on the ice.
Oh, man, that's a good play by Ozilic. Jumping up there, closing that off.
Wrapped around the board. Havlin able to cut his man off. Ozilic is hammered, but Niedermeyer will pick up the loose puck at center. Here's Niedermeyer. Barnes on the back check. The Stars able to take it away. In stride is Jason Arnott as Barnes towards the net. Arnott too late, took too much time. And a good defensive play by Havlin. Minute 15 left. Here's Arnott with a lane. Oates over to him. Here's Dahlin. Barnes in front of the net. Dahlin with one arm on his stick, one arm tied behind his back. Ozilic on top of him. Here's Arnott for Barnes. Oh, crossbar. Stu Barnes just put it off the crossbar in the final minute. Race for the puck. Here's Correa. He puts it off the outside of the net. Niedermeyer will get to it. He's pinning the boards there. Spun around. Philippe Boucher able to move it away. And come out. 45 seconds left now. We've had controversy. We've got an offside.
I don't want to look behind me, Shrug. That's a good shot, obviously. When you're a right-hand shot and you're playing against a butterfly guy, you wait for a bit.
Long shot. Turco handled it.
And then go high glove.
Here's Sikora. LeClaire is by Zubov. Madonna still working tirelessly in his own end. Race for the puck with 12 seconds left. Here's Sikora now. 8 seconds. They'll shoot it in softly. Stars fans who complained about the price increase in the first round of the second round of their tickets, they've gotten their money's worth tonight, I'll say. Two games for the price of one.
It wouldn't be conclusive. Right. They obviously feel it's conclusive. I did go talk to them. Mike Murphy of the National Hockey League did call and let everybody know that that's the rule, 57A. And it's a slight one, isn't it? Holy jumping. That thing just barely nudged. It did move, but it didn't move enough to get it off the pegs, but that doesn't matter in Rule 57A. You have to eliminate that from your mind, and that's hard to do. Face-off win here by Madonna.
Here's Hatcher. Shot blocked.
Oof, by
that
foot.
And that's one of those ways this could end. Shot blocked by Correa and races down the ice. So many ways. Who's going to be the hero tonight? And unfortunately, it's likely there will be a goat as well. Sent softly into the Dallas end. Icing is called. We are 35 seconds into our fourth sudden death overtime period. Face off to the right, John Sebastian Giguere. Here's Darryl Sidor, and it rolled back out to center. The 10th longest game in Stanley Cup playoff history. And we'll count it down with you as we continue on into the wee hours. Approaching Friday here in the Central Time Zone, already there in the East.
Well, Mike Modano not counting the first, not even minute of this period, Mike Modano's played 47 minutes and 11 seconds, 43:08 at even strength, and he's got two straight game-winning goals. And obviously, he's in the leading category.
Off the draw, quick shot was blocked, and a quicker stick by Turco to pull it back to him. We'll have another face-off. The three whistles already, 51 seconds in here.
Yeah, well, face-offs are, I mean, it's so critical here. Look at this face-off win right here. One quick play back, and if it doesn't hit Hatcher's two big feet, it ends up at least going on Turco, and it could have surprised him.
Face-off win to Dallas and Zubov. Out ahead, Letnin. The shift and the stick save, just enough by Jaguar. Here's Barnes. Letting into the front of the net, can't get there. Sikora was checking it. Shot in, Vishnevsky. Zubov up the boards. Letnin able to clear. We are now the ninth longest game in NHL Stanley Cup playoff history. Watching something very special here tonight, folks. Here's Turgeon trying to end it. Makes the move. He was stood up. Good play by Paulson. Got just enough to slow him down, and Paulson stays on his feet.
Yeah, good positioning by Paulson.
Here's Arnett now. Drop for Turgeon. And the right pad saves again. Arnett pushes it back behind the net. Turgeon is dumped by Ozalich. Still got it through to Arnett. Tied up by Chistov. And Thomas gets to it. Off a skate. And Ozalich.
How about that?
Out ahead, Thomas trying to tip it through. Robita off the glass and out. Sorry, Pat.
No, how about that defensive play by Chistov on Big Arnett? Chistov's only 5'10, 195 pounds. I mean, he was right back in his zone. He's known as an offensive player, but that's going to get the good grace of the coach, that's for sure.
Thomas floats the pass to Rucci. Here's run out. Puck cleared all the way down. A missed shot. Up ahead. Pass didn't click. Here come the Stars with Modano on the wrong side. And after the whistle, Modano let it go anyway. Ruchin to Correa. Slap that. Here's Letnin now. Letnin will shoot it around. Vishnovsky on it. Prague can't get there. Niedermeyer working the wall. DeMaio comes over. Off of Correa's skate, he'll come out. You seem to have a little more energy when you have the puck. Here's Correa, wrist shot through traffic. And a save by Turco with the stick. Rebound to Anaheim. Back behind the net. Here's Krog. Try to set up Correa. Vishnevsky will get to it. And actually shoots it into his own man, Krog. Vishnevsky's shot is blocked. And kicks out to center ice. Haviland. Off for Krog, trying to skip in by Hatcher. Nothing doing, I don't think so.
Nope. Hatcher's not wearing thin, that's for sure.
Barnes got it ahead. Here's Muller, hammer to the boards. Arnett gets there first, away from Shelvin. Barnes in a high slot, Carney on him. Back to the point, turn right over to Chouinard, and we get the whistle. Long shot. Boy, Jaguar looks cool, pointing out what direction the puck is going. And Ruchin overskated momentarily and now got it away. That's center. LeClaire can't get there. Sidor does. Sidor will shoot it around. Carney couldn't play it. Pushed towards the net. And Jaguar will hang on.
Played an outstanding game.
70 plus saves in that game. Five overtimes. Inside the duck zone. Here's DeMaio now, centered. Little Ducks without a stick. Haviland gets a stick from Correa. Like a good captain would do. And it's sent down on the Dallas end. Oh, behind the net, turned over to Oates. Oates swings it around and through everybody.
Oh, what a last second play by Letnin to get his stick jammed up against the hands of Adam Oates.
Zubov up the wall for Nico Kapanen. Kapanen will center for Darian Hatcher. We're 5 minutes in to our fourth overtime period. Two games and then some. And it's sent softly out to center. Race for the puck. Paulson and Zubov. Zubov got it away to Hatcher.
That's what we saw in the first overtime. Good aggressive forechecking.
Here's Young. Lets it go. Looked like he froze Jaguar there momentarily.
Yeah, Jaguar's so good with those angles, though. He probably the minute it was off his stick, he knew it was going wide. I mean, he just didn't even give it a move.
Welcome to now what is the eighth longest game. Not the eighth wonder of the world, but the eighth longest game in NHL Stanley Cup playoff history. Look, Dick Clark on New Year's Eve as we count it down.
I just don't see a time when it's going to end.
Coach, can we cancel practice for tomorrow yet?
I think it's canceled.
Here's Romanov. He'll shoot it around the boards. I would say both clubs have gotten their skating tonight.
I would say it's going to be extremely demoralizing for the team that loses.
Game two is just around the corner, Saturday afternoon on ABC.
Remember, the Pittsburgh Penguins couldn't regroup after that.
That's right. So, trying to connect with Barnes coming off the bench. There is Barnes. Backhand. Oh, trying to backhand it. Could get it in deep. Rod will get to it. Shoot it around. How late is the Stars Club open to anyway? 7 minutes in. Here's Boucher, and it's offside. Forget about it. You heard the whistle. No question. After the whistle, the puck was shot, and it went in. No controversy here. That will not count.
When the whistle goes automatically, I thought that was offside. I mean, automatically, when it happened. It's a lot closer when you take a look at it. On the replays.
There's been some close calls tonight.
Was it just a double hitch or just a little bit of a slowing down?
Linesmen have had their hands full here tonight.
Yeah.
Here's Lettman now. Jaguar knocks it away. Lettman still on it. Trying to make the move away from Sakura. Here's Yuri Lettman. Sour on him. Nico capping it to Miles all along. They couldn't get it to him. And Ozilin, you saw the patience there. He wanted to go and reach the puck, but he knew DeMaio was behind him, and he stayed in his position. Icing call.
As far as the referees and the off-ice officials are concerned.
Off the draw. Ducks get to it. There's Kuria. Sends it out to center. Would have been icing, but did not go far enough. It's cleared back. Here's Morrow. Off for Dolan. Dolan makes the shift away from Havlin. What a move by Dolan. Pulled down. Dolan on it. Turnaround save. Loose puck in front. And it's Anaheim that comes away. And Niedermeyer was taken down by Madonna at center. Sador is crunched by Rucin.
That kind of worked by Dolan's got to really suck the life out of him there, because that's a lot of hard work with the body on top of him.
Softly in. Here's Turgeon. Far side rolls up to Young. Turgeon back behind the net. Now the seventh longest game in NHL Stanley Cup playoff history. And now the sixth longest game in NHL Stanley Cup playoff history. The previous game, 6 and 7, was separated by 5 seconds. Working on something special tonight. Working on a little overtime tonight from Big D. They say everything's bigger in Texas. They didn't mention everything's longer in Texas. Here's Soleil. Backhanded in softly to the corner. Crunched down on the ice. How do these players keep picking themselves up off the ice? Anaheim change allows Dallas to pick it up. Muller will shoot him. Muller really finished his hit. Thomas out there. He'll flip it out to center. 37-year-old Kurt Muller looking rather fresh. Muller continues to play the body. 40-year-old Adam Oates put it by him. Steve Thomas on the ice, too.
Yeah, Muller hasn't played that much, so.
And they're offside at the Dallas blue line as Vishnevsky walked to the middle.
Kirk Muller at that time was a 15-year-old underager with the Kingston Canadians.
Past the midway, it's somewhat comical. Past the midway point in this quadruple overtime period, our seventh period of hockey. Tied at three. Welcome now to the fifth longest game in Stanley Cup playoff history. And the third longest ever televised. And across the line. Nucci will come back. Dangerous pass, nearly picked off by Morrow.
Sure was.
Five, let it go.
Not a bad idea. I mean, Turco hasn't seen a shot in a long time.
Yep. Shelberg on his backhand now. Morrow to him, turned it right over to Sidor. See if Dallas has the legs to break. Madonna's always got legs. They're just onside. Madonna, young in front. Niedermeyer got the stick in front. 9:03 left in a fourth overtime period. Game one, Western Conference semifinals. And we are live from Dallas, Texas. Niedermeyer, Sikora! And a right pad save by Marty Turco. It's maybe the best scoring chance in some time.
That is better than the
Mighty Ducks.
That is a great shot, and Marty Turco got his right pad on it against the green. And this isn't a re-air. This is live. We're in the seventh period. And Turco made a sharp save.
Say good morning to all of those in Dallas. Here in Dallas and watching in the Central Time Zone. It's Friday morning in the Central Time Zone and in the East. We work towards Mountain Time Zone now. SportsCenter is still coming up as soon as we are done, but it's so late now that Reese Davis has turned into Scott Reese. John Anderson replaced by Linda Cole. So Linda and Scott are standing by for SportsCenter whenever this be the end.
Maintain his position and then kick the leg out on the right side. That's a terrific, terrific save off a guy that can really shoot the puck.
Loose puck in the Anaheim end. Here's Haviland away from Barnes. Muller back for Barnes. On it to the front of the net. Loose puck. Schwinnard doing a good job taking his man down. Robina will get to it on the far side. Here's Barnes now. Barnes centered in front. Broken up. Loose puck to Anaheim. Muller on it. Through the traffic screen set by Arnett, but it never made it through.
Oh. Boy, another guy that's not getting enough credit in this game. We're talking about Carney, but boy, Haviland's had a heck of a hockey game on the blue line as well. Number 28 for the Ducks.
Here's Robina with wheels for Madonna. Speaking of speed, bouncing puck nearly tomorrow. Madonna overskated. It's amazing at this time of night you can still overskate. Too fast. Niedermeyer, shot block, and the rebound. Niedermeyer got his own rebound off the shot block. And Turco on the left pad save. Sauer shoots it around. Far side, there's Morrow. Shelberg for Niedermeyer. The crowd roaring. Those that are awake. Loose puck behind the net. And out to center. Race for it there. Soleil ahead of Morrow. Soleil and Morrow. Bit of a pitchfork job there at center.
That Soleil doesn't take very much. And you remember the situation with him and Madonna.
There's Carrillo's step. Carrillo is 1-on-3. It's amazing he could be in such good defensive position this late into the game. A credit to the Stars and the Mighty Ducks. Here's Lettinen now. Lettinen working on Ozilinch. Madonna's behind the net, picks up the loose puck. Here's Madonna for DeMaio. They cycle it down. Lettinen will get there first. Back down for Madonna. On his backhand, leaves for DeMaio. DeMaio checked. Lettinen hit by Sikora. Vishnevsky on there on DeMaio. And Krog is able to get it out to center. No icing, saying Zubov could have played it. Zubov, headman, Turgeon's in. The classy, crafty center iceman Turgeon. Backhander! And I don't think he got the shot away.
Sauer stayed with him the whole way.
Here's Chistov, Stanislav Chistov. Rubbed by Turco to let it go. We haven't had a whistle in some time now. 5.5 left in this fourth overtime period. We'll play forever. Dahlin on it. Cavallino will get to it. Not sure what he was waiting for there. He turned it over to Dolly. Back to the point. Boucher broke his stick. And here's Thomas looking ahead, man. Play broken up. And they're offside.
And identifies, you hope anyway, that puck's only going to go low. And certainly Giguère took away that part of the ice.
Here are the Ducks now. Back the other way. Here's Arnett. Lets it go on the far side. He's good on hand. He couldn't get there. Kept in. Arnett will get a second chance now. Arnett still holding. Muller to the side. Here's Matvichuk. Saved by Giguère. Matvichuk walked in and Giguère got it with the big shoulder. Twin Arnett will shoot into the corner.
That was a great setup down low. Muller communicated with Arnett, told him to keep going. That's going to be a two-line offside pass right there. And you know, you give up three after regulation. Your goals against average is high this day and age. It's three. Well, now it's not high anymore. Save percentage is outstanding, and goals against average just keeps shrinking.
Tipped by Morrow. They're going to call this icing, I believe.
Go.
No, he's waved it off.
Someone was not communicating very well.
That's been a trouble spot tonight. And this one is offside. For everyone in the ESPN truck working hard downstairs.
And we pass Rob Green, who does all the great work with Bob Bortz in the tape room there. 41st birthday, Greeny, great work.
He's got that Tigers hat probably
go,
on.
Go.
Cemented on, maybe. 3.5 left in this particular overtime period. Puck high on the glass. Jump puck. Sidor on the far side. Sidor will get a second crack. Sikora on top of him.
Whoa.
And the puck underneath and the whistle with 3:10 left in this period.
He stops a right-hand shot. He was set up to come around the circles.
Hatcher on it. He's been lugging that big body around all night. Here's Zubov, lets it go, and missed it. Sammy Paulson with the carry it out. Paulson out for Steve Thomas. Across the line, Turgeon the other way. Arnett will shoot it around. Turgeon's been one of the better players for Dallas in these latter overtime periods. Likely because he hasn't played much. Tip through traffic, Giguère the save. Turgeon's had plenty of time to shake the rust off anyway. After missing the previous 20 games, 14 in the regular season, 6 in the playoffs with the ankle injury. Turgeon back to Madonna. Look to go across. And the combination of Correa and Hatcher poke it.
Maybe he'll know the guys are tired. Maybe he'll be chomping a bit to play in game two. I think that's still unlikely. But wouldn't that be a pleasant thing for them?
Here's Young trying to wrap it around backhand to forehand. And a good job to stay with him all the way out of the Dallas end.
We've got to keep in mind that the strength and the power of Big Billy Guerin are his legs. And, you know, you got to be careful with the injury that he's got.
You don't think of a power forward as being one of the fastest skaters in the league. Speaking of which, here's McDonald cuts in. Saved by Giguère. And the rebound to Carney of Anaheim.
Oh, what a play.
Guerin once did win the speed skating contest, the skills competition for the All-Star game. We're going to expect that as a big man. Robita with wheels. On Havilland. Robita cuts behind the net. Still holding. Finds Sidor. Lets it go. It's blocked. Loose puck. Where is it? Dallas has it. And Young put it into the corner. Havilland will get to it. Wanted to flip it out. Didn't have the strength maybe to even do it. And that pass back to Sidor comes outside the zone. Here's a chance. Madonna will shoot it around. Only Ozilinch is there for Anaheim. Final minute of play in the fourth overtime period. Here's Sikora. Let's it go. Left hand save by Turco. Maybe on the skate. Looks like I might even hurt him.
Yep.
Get across the line. Drop past Cappity. Finds Lehtinen. Blocked by Giguère. And he'll hang on.
Shot by the right-handed Lehtinen.
Here's Soleil. Out to center. Barnes regroup away from Chouinard.
Yeah, see, he was thinking go backhand Sasher to Hatcher. I'm sure somebody on the bench said, you know, short side. Don't do that. Keep it on the boards.
Out ahead. Here's Krogan across the line with Chouinard. Zubov turned it over to Krog. Reaching in the high slot finds him. Reaching can't get the shot away. Turco will play. Plays it right to Reaching though. 11 seconds left in the overtime period. Reaching back to Soleil at the point. Soleil moves to the middle. Continues to move. Wrister. Loved by Turco. And he'll hang on. 1.3 seconds left. Want to pull the goalie if you're Anaheim?
No, I don't think so. I think they're going to probably add maybe a couple of tenths of a second on the clock anyway. Good traffic in front there. See, Ruchin's such a tough body, but there's nobody there by that time. Ruchin's watching, waiting. Soleil's already walked the line. He's already gone to the other side of the board. So by that time, I think Ruchin's a little out of gas. He's watching. He's battling Hatcher. I mean, Ruchin is no small guy. He's 6'3", 212, and he's going up against Hatcher, 6'5", 225 pounds.
Face-off to the right of Turco, and Jason Arnott wins it, and that horn sounds. Shots are 63-53, Dallas on top of Anaheim. The fourth longest game for now will continue on. We'll come back with a fifth sudden death overtime period. But first, John and Barry, back to you.
He was being pushed in by Robida, and the net just barely dislodged as that puck was going in the net.
Madonna tries to chip it towards the front of the net. It's so bizarre. The scoreboard reads under period 8. We are in our fifth overtime. Centered, Correa couldn't get there. Mauro Ken for Dallas the other way. Haviland able to get it out just at the line as Madonna and Correa battle there. Nicholas Haviland will move it ahead. Cross the red line and shoot it around. Turco couldn't get all of it. LeClaire in by Hatcher. Centered by shot. Score! There it is! In sudden death overtime, it's Peter Sikora. The game that would not end just has. And maybe justice has been served after the controversial goal ended up not counting. The Mighty Ducks of Anaheim defeat the Stars 4-3, 55 seconds of overtime. And a classy move by those that have stayed here in Dallas. An ovation for both clubs.